West Virginia's got a fine athlete, too. After looking at Joe Morris, we're going to look at Oliver Luck, their quarterback. You see his stats there. He's led West Virginia from sort of a medium team into a bowl-bound team. Possibility as a result of their good season this year. Rich Hollins on a reception, number 88. And we should see a lot of this combination today as West Virginia sporting an 8-2 record and a possible Peach Bowl berth, or we'll find out in a second just how possible it is. As we see this particular pass play right here for a touchdown. And Oliver Luck, number 12, their fine athlete, quarterback, does it again. And Syracuse got to stop that. Today, we'll see now. This is Penn State. Yes, it is. Tip ball. That one hurts, right, Coach? And you lost to Pitt and Penn State, two of probably the best teams in the country, and certainly two of the best teams in the East, so you certainly got nothing to be ashamed. What about Oliver Luck? What kind of an athlete is he, and how important is he to your offense?
Well, really, Oliver is kind of the soul of our offense. He does a lot of automatic, and at the line of scrimmage, we package our offense a great deal. By that, I mean we'll call a run and a pass, or we'll call two runs or two passes, and he comes out, reads the defense, and takes his choice. And you have to understand that Oliver Luck is such a winner all the way. I mean, he's a great player on Saturday, but he does everything right all the time. He's a 3.96 student in the classroom, and our football team really looks up to him. So we feel, you know, we're a little prejudiced to West Virginia, but we think he's as good as any of them.
You've had some interesting comments about your running game. We know Oliver Luck's a fine quarterback. Can you tell us a little bit about that running game?
Well, to be honest, that's what it would be, a little bit. We're trying to get better in the running game because I believe very strongly you can't win if you can't run, and you have to be able to run. And we probably don't run as badly as maybe I say we do, but I feel very strongly that we need to gain 200 yards a game every time we take the field rushing, and we haven't been able to do that all the time.
What about that bowl situation? We mentioned it. Is it assured now, or it's a kind of an iffy thing? What is it?
Well, let me say this to you. We're going to go to a bowl. I'm sure of that.
Well, that's good, Coach. Good luck today, and thank you very much for taking time out to talk to us.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Syracuse co-captains, Joe Morris, 47-32, Ike Bogosian, with the officials getting set to meet the West Virginia co-captains, number 12, their fine All-American candidate quarterback, Oliver Luck, a senior from Cleveland, Ohio, and number 99, Calvin Turner, a defensive tackle, a senior at 6'3 and 250 pounds from Fairmont, West Virginia. The referee for the ball game is Roy Chapman, the umpire, Donald McDonald. The linesman is Bill Cronin, the Lions judge, Joe Carroll, the field judge, Vincent Scarzi, and the back judge is Joseph DiRenzo Jr. The officials now escorting Captain Joe Morris and Captain Ike Bogosian to the center of the field to meet with the West Virginians and also their honorary captain, number 51, John Garcia, who is injured and unable to play. 99 is Turner, and number 12 is Oliver Luck. Syracuse, Joe Morris, and Ike Bogosian.
Captain Luck, Captain Garcia, Captain Turner, Captain Bogosian, and Captain Barnes. Your officials this afternoon, gentlemen, Mr. DiRenzo, the back judge, Mr. Carl, your line judge, Mr. Cronin, your linesman, Mr. McDonald, your umpire, and Mr. Scazzi, your field judge. Your clock operator at official time is Mr. Stankovic. Who is the spokesman for the visiting team? 51 will call the toss. If I toss it again, this is... He calls heads. Heads it is. You win the toss. Kick. Goal. He would like to... Goal. Step right around.
High at Syracuse will kick off to the Mountaineers of West Virginia, the Peach Bowl-bound Mountaineers of West Virginia. They will play the winner of the Florida-Florida State game in the Peach Bowl in Atlanta. Syracuse leads the series 17 wins to 11. Syracuse has won the last four in a row in 77, 28-9, in 78, 31-15, in 79, 24-14, and last year they upset the Mountaineers 20-7. That was Coach Don Nealon's first season at West Virginia. He wound up 6-6. He needed that win for a winning season, but in his second season at the helm of the Mountaineers, he has led them to an 8-2 record so far and into the Peach Bowl, despite what happens here at the Carrier Dome today against the Orangemen of Syracuse. Dick McPherson looking for his fourth win of the season. The Orange 3-6-1, and would love to go out a winner, putting back-to-back wins against Boston College and West Virginia together. That would be a great help recruiting for Syracuse. It would be a great psychological lift, a great morale boost, and it would be certainly a fitting way for all these seniors to go out, particularly Dave Warner and Joe Morris. Syracuse will be losing, if you include the two kickers, Gary Henderson and Joe Ross, as part of the starting team. You've got 24 starters, 11 offense, 11 defense, and the two kickers. Syracuse is graduating 13 of the 24, 8 of them on offense, including Jim McAndrews, Tony Hazen, John Lally, John McCollum, all out of the offensive line. And then both wide receivers, Willie Sidner, Paul Zambuda, the quarterback, Dave Warner, and the tailback, Joe Morris. Also, Gary Anderson, the kicker, and Joe Ross, the punter. Syracuse loses only 3 seniors on defense, Guy Ruff, Mike Jetbay, Jerry Kilpatrick. We are ready to play football. Anderson's boot. It's hooking over toward the far corner, caught deep in the end zone by number 48, Willie Drury, and he will hold on to it, and the ball will come out to the 20-yard line, where it'll be West Virginia first and 20 against the Orange.
It'll be interesting to see what Syracuse does defensively. Last week against another passing team with Doug Flutie at quarterback, they put in a 4-man rush, put in Bill Pendock, but we'll see what happens. We get a look at the offensive line and the offensive backs from West Virginia and see what that Syracuse defense is facing.
Only one setback. Luck is going to throw on first down. Fires to his wide receiver, Gary Mullen, and Mullen brings it over to 25 to about the 28-yard line before he's hit by 54, Tony Romano.
Quick little screen pass to set things off, kind of get Oliver Luck warmed up, I think. Don't want to go long and have an incompletion, right? Set him back, but they go for a little short screen, and it gives him about 9 yards.
Incidentally, number 42 in the offensive backfield for West Virginia, surprise starter Mickey Walczak, a junior from Saratoga Springs, New York. From the eye, Luck goes over the middle of Mullen at the 41. He gets to the 43-yard line, hit by Coban and Kilpatrick.
Ran a little bit of a crossing pattern there, and Syracuse big cushion for Jerry Mullen, the wide receiver, who very good hands. We look at the Syracuse defense: Charles, Butsky, Hand, Bingham, Romano, Ruffin, Jetbay, Coban, Hobby, Frederickson, and Kilpatrick. The secondary that looks to be a little bit busy today.
With Craig Bingham in there, then that adds another senior to the starting defense. Here's Walczak, gets good blocking at the line of scrimmage, gets over the 50 in the Syracuse territory at the 48-yard line before he's hit by freshman Ron Hobby, number 10.
And mixed the plays up well, going with the screen early, test the outside linebackers for Syracuse, and then going a little bit longer to the wide receiver, then come up with that draw play. So Coach Nealon said his running game, not much, but when you can set it up with your passing game, it certainly helps to set him up, and a nice run by Walczak.
The Mountaineers looking for their ninth win of the season. They have lost only to Pittsburgh and Penn State. I formation, wide receivers both ways, a fake to Walczak, a throw to their leading receiver, the tight end, Mark Rowe, and Eddie Coban rolls him out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. Number 85, Mark Rowe, it's spelled R-A-U-G-H, and he is their top receiver.
Nice pass delivered by Oliver Luck, and Rowe just picks the ball up and breakdown in coverage because Coban comes up and makes the tackle, but there was no one around him when he received the ball, and Syracuse secondary got to play a little bit tougher if they expect to stay in this game.
Luck is 3-for-3 for 38 yards. Wide receivers both ways, open field left. There's a give to Walczak. Walczak to the 30-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 2 yards.
Syracuse defense has gone back to the same defense they used last week. They put Pendock, Bill Pendock, number 72, in at the nose guard. Blaze Winter, number 98, is in, and they're running a 4-man rush to attempt to put some pressure on Oliver Luck.
Second and about 8 for the Mountaineers. Open field to the near sideline for senior quarterback Oliver Luck. Luck right back into the pocket. Sets up, throws. It is complete at the 19-yard line to number 19, Wayne Brown.
Wayne Brown ran a nice pattern, a little bit of a curl. You can tell that Oliver Luck is used to playing with his receivers. They augment each other very well. They complement. Watch Oliver Luck. Delivers the ball. The pattern, actually, we don't see it yet, but he wasn't even looking at the ball. He was running his pattern. He turned around. The ball was delivered, and he's only a freshman. Good catch by Brown, and that sets up a first down on the Syracuse 19.
A pitch to Walczak. Off right tackle. He'll get about 2 yards. Mickey Walczak, 200-pound junior from Saratoga Springs. That is the hometown of Syracuse's starting offensive tackle, Jimmy McAndrews, a senior at 280 from Saratoga Springs. So they must have played some high school football together. Walczak is a junior at West Virginia. McAndrews is a senior at Syracuse. This time they run the two wide receivers to the open side of the field. Tight end is to the right. Over the middle, hits the tight end at the 13-yard line, and he gets to about the 11.
You can tell the problem with the defense. That number 86, tight end on the ball there, caught that ball, turned around expecting to get hit, and he wasn't hit. Got a chance to take two steps upfield. They got to play tighter on those ends.
There you see the statistics on Mark Rao. So far today, he's caught three passes for 32 yards. Luck is 5 for 5 for 55 yards. Third and 3. Luck's going to throw again. No, he's not.
He fumbled that ball.
They're going to rule that a fumble. You never saw the official indicate that it was anything other than a fumble. Now let's see what they're going to do to sort it all out. Luck tried to roll the ball ahead. Siebert had a lot of pressure on him. There was no way he was going to be able to throw the ball. He was caught. And it looked like he tried to shovel the ball ahead, but roll it on the ground.
They haven't even spotted the...
Now, where are they going?
They're going to rule that an incomplete pass. And that's amazing.
That's how it is. It's going to be a field goal attempt from the 19-yard line. It'll be a 29-yard field goal attempt. Kick is up. It's high enough and far enough and good. Field goal by Paul Woodside, number 6 for the Mountaineers.
Syracuse defense hung tough on that last play, although somewhat controversial in terms of exactly what happened.
Nobody ever indicated fumble, incomplete pass, or anything.
Nobody did anything, and then Syracuse actually was starting to line up where they had tackled Luck, and then the officials walked back and set the ball, spotted the ball at the previous line of scrimmage. So, kind of an unusual call, and the officials huddling at the end of the field. I assume they're trying to get themselves straightened out. That last play didn't make them look very good. Syracuse, though, did something interesting. They sent a 5-man rush on that particular play, put the pressure on Oliver Luck, and actually saved themselves from a possible touchdown because they only needed about 3 for a first, Carl.
Well, there were 6 passing plays, including that questionable incompletion, and 3 running plays. Walczak carried on all 3 running plays, picked up 14 yards. Luck was 5 out of 6 for 55 yards. 2 of them caught by Mullen. Number 1 is wide receiver. The other 3 by Rao, his tight end. Then they get a 29-yard field goal by Woodside to lead the ball game 3-0. Woodside, number 6, will kick it off to the Mountaineers. The Morris brothers are back deep. 47, Joe Morris, and 36, Mike Morris. For the Orange. Mike, a freshman. Joe, a senior. This is Joe Morris Day in Onondaga County. As Joe goes out, the leading rusher in Syracuse University history and one of just a half a dozen or a dozen college football runners in history who have gained over 4,000 yards. The younger Morris brother catches it and downs it in the end zone, so it'll come out to the 20-yard line where it'll be first and 10 for Syracuse, trailing 3-0 with 11:13 left to play in the first period here at the Carrier Dome. Pretty good crowd. It's a cold and wet and rainy day, and just perfect for conditions inside under the dome.
There's the offensive line that we see set there, and now the Syracuse offensive backs, the receivers, Zambudo, Morris, Gilligan, and of course Dave Warner, Gilligan now starting at fullback, but he's being replaced by Ziegler, 43. Listed as a starter, Ziegler comes in to start.
Joe Morris is throwing the ball. Zambuto.
Oh!
40-yard line. A beautiful pass floated downfield down the sideline by Joe Morris.
You'll see right here, it's just a pitch. Joe Morris throws very well, and he leads Zambuto just a little bit too much. Zambuto makes a diving attempt. He had two steps on number 44 for the Mountaineers, Tim Agee, but it was not to be, but a nice attempt, and it brought the crowd to their feet.
Second and 10. Ziegler, the fullback, Joe Morris, the tailback. Wide receivers to both sidelines. A fake to Joe Morris. A pitch to Ziegler. Ziegler will get to around the 23 or 24-yard line. It'll be a 3 or 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it third down and about 6 for the Orange. A little fullback screen over the middle.
West Virginia uses basically a 5-2, except they play their ends somewhat of a soft technique, which means the defensive ends can drop off and play pass. It's very similar to Syracuse's 3-4. So not an unusual defense for Syracuse to play. A lot of teams they have played have employed this particular defense. Of course, one of the keys right there, number 52, Jerry Fury, the offensive center.
Split backs this time. Third down and 6 yards to go. Warner's going to get hit from behind, and he does. Number 35, Don Stemple, comes in and whacks Warner from behind, and that'll make it fourth down, and Syracuse's Joe Ross, a senior from Pittsburgh, will have to kick it away.
He had a pretty good amount of time to throw, and I think he didn't realize the Stemple sent from the outside. They've had trouble stopping an outside rush, had a little bit of a problem. And Syracuse also having a bit of a problem as Gordon Gronkowski just checks in.
48 is deep. Billy Drury for the Mountaineers. Up a little closer is number 24, Reggie Armstead. And a punt away. Angling toward the sideline and out of bounds.
Good punt.
Joe Ross, who has been punting at slightly better than a 40-yard per kick average, boots one over the sideline. 54 yards. No return, out of bounds at the 33-yard line.
You know what's impressive about that is that they needed that particular punt. It's easy to have a 40-yard average, but you got to be able to kick them when you need it. That was a good punt by Ross.
Back is Dane Conwell, number 32. Walzak, the tailback. Luck looking to throw to the far sideline. He's got Rao, his tight end, and Coban has a tough time getting him out of bounds. Although apparently he was out of bounds farther backfield at the 45-yard line. Looked like he was carrying Coban along with him up near midfield and beyond, but the official over on that sideline ruled that he had gone out of bounds at the 45-yard line. A little over a 10-yard gain, so it is first down for the Mountaineers at their own 45, leading 3-0, 9.5 minutes remaining. In the opening period of play, Walzak gets across the 45 to the 46.
Chris Hand, a linebacker who used to be a defensive tackle, been converted to get a little bit of better pass rush, came up very nicely there. Good, tough tackle, second and 9. Syracuse changing defensive personnel and defensive alignments frequently.
Senior quarterback Oliver Luck. He'll be leading the Mountaineers into the Peach Bowl in Atlanta, Georgia. Stumbles at the 45, and that is very close to and may be slightly beyond what he needed for the first down, so that'll be about a 10-yard run for Oliver Luck. It is a first down for Luck.
You hate to see, if you're a defensive coach, hate to see the quarterback able to scramble and pick up a first down. But it does indicate one thing. In that particular play, the secondary had their men covered, forcing Luck to run the ball. If you can make him run all day, you're going to be pretty well off.
That's the fullback, Conwell, number 32, okay. Dane Conwell, who picks up about 4. That'll make it 2nd and 6.
Coach Nealon was joking about his running game in the paper. He said, we tell them to go right and they go left. And he said, we really don't have much of a running game. The leading rusher has some 450 yards. But with Oliver Luck throwing the throwing the passes. I guess they feel they don't need that much of a running game.
Over the middle to Walczak, and Walczak gets it to about the 34, 33-yard line, just what they needed for a first down.
I think they're going to measure here. A great play by Walczak. He just slipped out of the backfield. The fullback, kind of tailback, stepped up, delayed, came through. Yes, they're going to give him the first down. The linebacker's got to pick up the back out of the backfield, especially on that quick curl right over the middle.
First down for the Mountaineers at the Syracuse 33-and-a-half. 7.5 minutes left to play in the first period, and it is West Virginia 3-0 with a 29-yard field goal. There's Walczak to the 30 and into the 28-yard line, letting the New York State youngster get a lot of exposure early in the ball game here at the Carrier Dome. Walczak, the junior from Saratoga Springs, having himself a very good first period.
Uses his back very well, Luck does, and that's a mark of a good quarterback. When your primary receivers are covered, you got to go to your backs, deliver the ball. Walczak knows what to do with it. Second and about five. Short five.
To the 25-yard line.
Mike Jetbay lets him know that he's around. They're a little bit late, but he certainly gave him a shot. Good pressure inside, but a quick pass. Walczak just couldn't hold on to it. It was delivered perfectly. He dropped the ball. I think he was going to look upfield, ready to run. Ball was there, and he dropped it.
You know, Don Nealon made a very interesting observation, Dale, when we were having some conversation with him just prior to starting the ball game. He said that these kids don't know that they're not a very good football team. They think they're pretty good.
That's half the battle.
He said they don't have exceptional personnel. They're not a very good or strong football team, but they've won 8 ball games, and they're going to the Peach Bowl. Walczak trying to get around the corner and does. Gets to the 20 and maybe the 19-yard line.
For a team that doesn't have a very good running game, they've been able to mix their plays very well, and a little bit of a counter option. Oliver Luck got the pitch out. Romano chasing, but very, very difficult when you're putting pressure on from inside out. You like to see that pressure come from outside in. Have your corner come up and help on that particular play to pick up the first down. And Syracuse defense is showing that they're having a little bit of trouble with this West Virginia outfit. If you look at first downs,
West Virginia has had the ball for 2 possessions. This is their second one. They've got 8 first downs. Syracuse had it for 1 possession, wasn't able to make a first down. Rao at the 12-yard line. Kilpatrick brings him down at about the 11 with some help from Tony Romano. And Luck is building up to what might be a record-smashing day. He is already 9 for 11. And right around 90 yards.
Syracuse defense got to play a little bit more aggressively. They're laying off the receivers, looking, hoping that they don't get beat. But I think Coach McPherson would like to see them a little bit tighter and take a little more risk.
Second and 2 for the Mountaineers. Open field to the right. The fullback, Conwell. Conwell's to the 3-yard line. Right off, right tackle. No fancy stuff. Just take the ball, put your head down, and grind it out.
Syracuse offense, as you said, just one possession. Haven't had much of a chance to help out on what could be a long day here with West Virginia up 3-0, threatening again, and Syracuse defense showing an inability to really consistently put any pressure on the run game or the pass game of West Virginia.
Conwell gets maybe a half a yard. Jetbay in on the tackle, number 94, along with Romano, 54. Luck looks over toward head coach Don Nealon, a graduate of Bowling Green, 1958 graduate of Bowling Green. He was a quarterback on his college football team. In his second year heading the Mountaineers, he was 6-6 last year and could be 9-2 or maybe 10-2 with a bowl win this year. Luck is stopped at the 5-yard line. Quarterback draw. He just took one step back, thought he saw something over left guard, but there was nothing there.
Ralph Jolene, second team middle guard, came up with a big tackle, and he just fights off the block along with Bingham, comes over and stops Oliver Luck for nothing. Again, the Syracuse defense getting very, very tough down near this, near the goal line. It's third, about the same position it was the last time that they had that strange incompletion.
is going to throw for it. He's got Rao in the end zone for a touchdown. With 4:07 left to play in the opening period, a 5-yard touchdown pass from quarterback Oliver Luck to his leading receiver, the tight end, Mark Rao, makes a nice catch, beats Coban in the corner of the end zone, and they put 6 more on the scoreboard, and Woodside now will attempt the extra point. Very high, very quickly, and yes, it is perfect. And that makes it 10-0 with 4:07 left to play in the opening period here at the Carrier Dome. WCNY Sports would like to express its very sincere thanks to Doug Logan and all the people connected with WSYR Radio and the Syracuse University Radio Football Network for allowing us this week to place a camera in their broadcast booth. Probably very crowded in there and uncomfortable for them. They have accommodated us when we were under a lot of pressure to find a place for a camera, ABC TV, telecast this ball game live, and they have come in with a lot of people and a lot of equipment. And they've used up an awful lot of room in the press box, and we had nowhere to go with our camera. But Doug Logan and the folks at WSYR, Doug and Jimmy Ridline and the rest of the people responsible for the Syracuse University Football Network, graciously allowed us to put our camera in their booth, inconveniencing them, but making it possible for us to continue with the best kind of coverage we can give you on the statewide level for Syracuse University football. So we're very grateful to them.
Well, the Syracuse offense has to see if they can take some pressure off the Syracuse defense and give them a chance to get regrouped. The defense has given up 10 points in less than 12 minutes in the first quarter. Excuse me, a little more than 11 minutes, but offense has got to do a job right now if Syracuse is going to get back in this football game.
Woodside kicks it high and long, right at the goal line. Larry Morris. Larry to about the 18-yard line.
I believe that's Mike.
Excuse me, Mike Morris.
Well, there's so many here that we do have. We
and
mentioned
there's one
before,
more coming, too.
And there may be one more coming who's only a sophomore out of Air Mats. But right now we have three here, Joel, Larry, and Mike. And we'll see Mike Morris, number 36, who has 9-2 speed. His brother blocks for him there. He can't find a seam, bounces off for a second, but...
That was a heck of a defensive play by 59, Scott Dixon, who fought off 3 blockers and stayed right with Morris and brought him down. At the 18 or 19-yard line. Catches it again, this time from Cedric King, number 15.
Syracuse has had trouble stopping the outside rush. They had trouble against Colgate with it, and they just send what seems to be a designated stunner, and they send him. He came from the right side, outside defensive end spot. He's not a defensive end. He's a defensive back, but they're sending the defensive backs, and they figure the best way to stop the Syracuse passing attack and not let them get the ball off. And so far, they've done an excellent job. Syracuse facing now. They're in a big hole, second and about 20.
Joe Morris brings it back to the 15-yard line. That will be still a couple of yards short of the original line of scrimmage. So Syracuse will have third and long, third and about 13 yards.
It's interesting to note on that stunt where they sent the outside linebacker, defensive back, all the motion went to the right, and they're leaving the left side unprotected. There's not even a back there who can pick up the on-rushing defensive back. As a result, Dave Warner is just back there by himself, and he got nailed. Setting up now at third and about 14.
Let's it go for Willie Sittner, and Willie won't catch up with it. He's about 5 yards behind it, being matched stride for stride by Cedric King, number 15. Warner just lofted it down the sideline and hoped that Sittner would run under it, but it fell about 5 yards ahead of where Sittner and the defensive back were. So it is fourth and long, and Joe Ross is in to punt it for the Orange. He got off a 54-yard punt his first time, standing just about where he is now, very close to the end zone. Put it out of bounds, 54 yards downfield. by Peter Kaufman, and the punt is away. This one is far short, and will be brought back to the 40-yard line by Reggie Armstead, number 24.
So the Syracuse defense once again going to be tested. They haven't been able to stop the West Virginia Mountaineers, and West Virginia are going to set up this play right here at their own, the Syracuse 40-yard line. So they've got good field position, and they've shown the ability to move the football, and the Syracuse defense is going to have to gamble a little bit, I think, put a lot of more pressure on Oliver Luck.
33-yard punt, 8-yard return by Armstead. Tees it up on the 40-yard line. West Virginia's had the ball for two possessions. They have a field goal and a touchdown to show for it. Syracuse has had it for two possessions and has yet to make a first down. The Orange has dug itself a hole behind 10-0 with 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first period.
They always seem sluggish in that first half. All this year, they seem to be the kind of team that gives up a little bit in the first half and comes on in the second half.
Well, you know, it's an interesting observation, Dale, and the statistics bear that out. Syracuse has been outscored by 57 points by the opposition in the first half of play, and has come back to outscore the opposition by 37 in the second half. So for a net loss of a total of 20 points being outscored over the course of the season. But Syracuse has been outscored by 9 in the first period and by 48 points in the second period for a total of 57 in the first half. They played them even in the third period and have outscored the opposition by 37 points in the fourth period. One setback, slot back right. The one setback, Conwell, the fullback, gets the handoff and goes to about the 36-yard line.
We had a look at Don Nalen before while we were talking about Syracuse's propensity for second-half comebacks. Don Nalen done a good job with this West Virginia team, and Syracuse has won the last four games, as we mentioned at the top of the show. But he does a really good job with this material, and he's interestingly, he says these kids don't know how, but not quite as good as they appear to be. But right now, they're doing a pretty good job against Syracuse.
Walczak hit by Chris Hand at the 35-yard line. Blaze Winter also in on the play. Short gain. The ball's at the 34-yard line. That'll make it third down and about 4.
I might look for Walczak to pick a pass up here. I think Nealon, Coach Nealon, likes the way Oliver Luck can look downfield and then drop the ball off to his back.
He's got Mullen, his wide receiver, who was set out to the right. Eddie Coban hits them, but after Luck's pass to Mullen, gets them out, there's a first down at about the 26 and a half yard line.
A little bit of a rolling pocket. Oliver Luck looking for Mullen the whole way, and Mullen, knowing exactly where that sideline marker is, comes up with the first down.
Mullen comes to the open side of the field at the near sideline this time. First and 10. Luck back to throw. Drops it off to Walczak over the middle. Tony Romano gets him at the 21-yard line.
That's the play I thought they might use before this, but they've shown great success with dropping the back out of the backfield. Linebackers have to respect that. They have to come up and cover, do the under coverage. Secondary, of course, has that deep responsibility, but all the under stuff has to be picked up by the linebackers. And they're giving up about 5 yards or 6 yards a catch. And from what I've seen, to Walczak in that particular play, they've used it quite a bit.
Second down and 5 yards to go. 25 seconds remaining in the first period. Walczak on a little delay gets to the 17 or 18 yard line, hit by Guy Ruff, number 30.
It's going to be a little short of the first down. They marked his forward progress back a bit. He kind of bounced. His knee touched the turf, and he bounced ahead to what appeared to be a first down, but they're going to spot it about, I'd say, a yard and a half short of that first down. Big third down play now.
Time will tick off, and it does in the first period, and that is the end of the first period with West Virginia leading Syracuse 10-0. The Mountaineers scored with 11:13 remaining in the period on a 29-yard field goal by Paul Woodside, and then about 7 minutes later came back on a 5-yard pass to Mark Rowell from Oliver Luck. at the end of a 67-yard, 13-play drive. The extra point was good by Woodside, and that made it 10-0, and that's the score at the end of the first period of play. West Virginia 10, and the Orange of Syracuse University nothing, as West Virginia had the ball for two possessions in the first period, scored both times, won a field goal, won a touchdown. Syracuse had the ball for two possessions in the first period and was unable to pick up a first down. Now West Virginia with their third possession of the ball game, and they are deep in Syracuse territory.
And we see the monitor right there, the 0-2 and 3-4 third down conversions. Syracuse very unimpressive offensively, been in a hole, and right now I think this is a crucial play for the Syracuse Orange men, because if they can hold West Virginia to a field goal here, they can certainly come back, score two touchdowns and be ahead. But if they give up that touchdown, they're going to be in a little bit of trouble, especially with the inability, they've shown the inability to stop the offense of West Virginia.
West Virginia, pretty good scoring football team. They got 32 against Virginia, 49 against Colorado State, 38 against Boston College, 27 against Virginia Tech, 20 against East Carolina, 24 against Temple. They scored 20 on Rutgers, so this team put a lot of points on the scoreboard. Third down and two from inside the 20-yard line.
Oh!
Good hit by 94 Jet Bay. And he may have held him from the first down. It's going to be close.
Well, the official's got his foot spotted, and it looks to be a little bit short. Could force a field goal, or... no, they're going to go for it, I believe. We'll see. There's a timeout now taken by West Virginia. Mike Jetfay. Good hit.
This is our final telecast of the season of Syracuse University football. We have really enjoyed bringing you the ball games from both the Carrier Dome, Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, College Park, Maryland, University of Illinois. We hope you've enjoyed our telecast. I know a lot of you have. You've taken the time to write to us, and we certainly do appreciate that. We hope to be back next year. If you'd like to see us come back next year, your letters will help. So if you'd write to us at WCNY-TV, Old Liverpool Road, Liverpool, New York, 13088, you'd help ensure Syracuse University football on television next season. Thank you very much. Well, they've apparently elected not to go for the first down. It's about a yard short. Jet Bay's hit kept them from getting the first down on third. They picked up less than a half a yard, so it is fourth and a long yard. And Woodside is setting it up at the hash mark toward the near sideline at the 25-yard line for what will be a 35-yard field goal attempt, if it is indeed an attempt and not a fake.
Great place for a fake. I really think that they might think this way. They've got nothing to lose. They're ahead by 10 points now. They might be able to put them away on a fake, but we'll see if Coach Nealon is conservative or is the type who wants to gamble a little bit.
No good.
The Syracuse gets a break on a tough tackle by Mike Jetfay out of East Orange, New Jersey. Jetfay's a big one, 6'3", 239 pounds. That's the size you like in a linebacker. And we'll see the kick here as it goes just a little bit to the right.
Oh, that's hard to tell when
yes,
it gets it up
is.
That high and so far above the uprights.
At any rate, Syracuse gets a break there because now they're only down by 10, but they've got to do something offensively on this series. I'd like to see Warner run the ball a little bit.
Crowd comes to life, exhorting Syracuse and Joe Morris, and Joe picks up a couple to about the 24-yard line. Joe Morris, the senior captain from Ayer, Massachusetts, Syracuse's all-time leading rusher, and one of a dozen or so in the history of NCAA football to gain 4,000 yards. Incredible when you think of all the running backs over the more than 100 years of college football to think that only 14 or 15 have gained 4,000 yards, and Joe Morris is one of them. He is also a 4,000-yard individual, too. There's the pitch to Joe. Joe gets to the 25 or 26. Lassoed there by Dennis Folks, number 50, F-O-W-L-K-E-S, pronounced Folks.
As Joe mentioned, he was not highly recruited out of high school by Division I schools. They all felt he was a little bit short. But as you mentioned, he's certainly not short when it comes to what he's given Central New York in terms of drills. One of the things about his rushing yards, he's also a major, and he only played on one winning team, and that's quite a credit to Joe Morris.
Third and four. Early in the second period, West Virginia leading 10-0. Warner looking for that first down. He's not going to get it. A
lot of pressure put on Warner right away. They had that play figured out. A little bit of a bootleg, and Warner, again, Syracuse offense bogged down, forcing Jay Ross to come in and put his foot into it.
Syracuse with three possessions so far, no first downs, and three punts. This will be the third one by Joe Ross. There's Kaufman's snap, and the punt's away. Excellent. Into the 19-yard line. Taken by Drury. Pretty good open field running by Drury, and he brings it back to close to the 40-yard line.
Let's not take anything away from him, but that was pretty poor open field tackling that made that particular play.
Another 54-yard punt by Joe Ross, and a 20-yard return by Drury.
And we'll watch him as he gets the ball and just cuts off. Let's see the tackles. There's an arm. There's two arm tackles right there. There's a third arm tackle. And he hasn't even hit anybody yet. He hit his own man. Not good for special teams coverage for Syracuse.
And you see, again, Drury is a freshman. You're going to see a lot of freshmen in there for West Virginia today. I think Coach Nealon told us he's got 13 to 15 freshmen who will be playing today. Now, those are all his recruits, this being his second year at the University of West Virginia. And they've gotten a lot of playing time this season, not necessarily because they're better than the people who were there, but they have been plagued by a number of injuries too, but that has given him the opportunity for a lot of those freshmen some game action. And as I say, he said that he probably, there'd be 13 to 15 freshmen who would get a lot of playing time during this ball game today.
You know, one thing we should mention, Syracuse defense much maligned, as we see they're down 10-0, but the Syracuse offense, especially today, has done nothing to take any pressure off of the defense. And when your defensive players are out there for as long as Syracuse's defense is, things begin to break down a little bit. And if you have a defense that is not exceptional, you want them on the field as little as possible. And the exact opposite has happened. Syracuse offense has kept the Syracuse defense out a little bit too long, and Syracuse defense is going to have to come up with some big plays to keep Syracuse in the game. It's up to the defense now.
At the 39-yard line, first and 10 for the Mountaineers. Footbacks, wide receivers, both sides. Luck back to throw, looking for the screen. Pass is complete. Pendock makes the tackle at about the 47-yard line. Fumble. Syracuse has recovered.
Well, that's what Syracuse had to do. The defense has to come up with a big play. They've given up 8 yards before the fumble, and Siebert, I believe, came up with it. And that's going to give Syracuse's offense a lift. It's one of the best field positions they've had all game. And we'll see right here.
Good hit by Pendock. Watch it coming from the right. There it is. There's the ball bouncing loose. Siebert's got it. Syracuse's 13th fumble recovery of the season. And the first one for Tommy Siebert. At the 48-yard line, Ziegler to the 45, the youngster from West Islip, Long Island. On the subject of Islip, Long Island, I noticed in the paper this week, Dale, that a youngster from East Islip High School set a new state high school record with a 53-yard field goal. A fellow named Dom McCauley from East Islip, Long Island, 53-yard field goal.
A lot of football players from Long Island on the field, especially for Syracuse. Right now, Gilligan picked up about three.
To the 46-yard line, Joe Morris, hit by Jeff Seals, number 80, their outside linebacker.
You see number 50, Dennis Fultz, the defensive linebacker, showing blitz and then dropping off, coming up. They want to put a lot of pressure on Syracuse, get them thinking offensively. They want to take the outside away, and by coming up rather quickly, They can screw up the option. They can really mess up a lot of the plays by penetrating, and they did on that play, but Syracuse now forces a big 3-5.
Going to be short by a couple of yards. Warner tried to pick it up himself, hit by Jeff Seals, number 80.
Interesting alignment on that West Virginia defense. It's almost like Dallas's flex. They don't line up straight across the line of scrimmage. They have the defensive end back a bit, their nose guard up tight. Makes it very difficult to trap the defense, and it gives them good lanes in which to penetrate. And they've shown a good, tough defense, and right now, they're going to be put to the test, and Syracuse is going to go for it on fourth and short.
All right, the double tight end, straight T offense. Well, they're going to get the first down on a penalty. They got it anyway, but they would have gotten it on the penalty.
Well, it's a stunning defense. They're trying to draw Syracuse offside. Hope that one of the offensive linemen will jump. It's a gambling defense. It didn't work on that particular play. We'll see on the call. I'm assuming it's against, yes, it is against West Virginia. So Syracuse gets a free 5 yards and a free first down.
Watch we'll number right 50 here, to the linebacker.
Folks again. And he's the man that we saw before trying to put pressure on. He steps up and back and hopes that one of the offensive
offside
linemen will jump.
Defense, first down.
That could be the break Syracuse offense needs because they've yet to pick up a first down, rushing or passing. They got one on a penalty.
Although they would have had that rushing.
Yes, they would have.
Ten and a half minutes remaining in the opening half of play at the Carrier Dome. 10-0, West Virginia leads Syracuse. The Orange has a first down at the Mountaineer 35. Just tripped up by number 55 of the Mountaineers. That's Dave Oblak, O-B-L-A-K, or Warner would have had himself plenty of yardage.
Warner's shown a good ability to do that before, but they're doing a nice job of containing him. They're not falling down. They're keeping their lanes open, and when Warner's going to run with the ball, there's always somebody there ready to pursue. Watch Warner now. He'll cut back. But right there, two West Virginia Mountaineers, number 55, Bob Bennett, and number 35, John Stempel.
Joe gets across the 35 to about the 34-yard line. Pickup of a yard, and that'll make it 3rd and 9.
This defense of West Virginia, they send people from all over. Number 15, good pursuit. Defensive back Cedric King, close to stopping the play from a stunning outside linebacking spot. Syracuse is going to have to pick them up.
Third and 9. Wide receivers to both sidelines. Sidner left and Zambuto right. Over the middle to Willie Sidner at the 17-yard line. First down for Syracuse. 1st and 10 at the 17-yard line. Willie Sidner catches his first pass in several weeks. Willie, still the leading receiver with 26 receptions this season, about 340 yards. His first one in a couple of weeks, he got hurt in the Pitt game and really hasn't been at full strength since. He missed the next ball game and saw limited service after that. So Willie catches his first pass, his 26th of the season. Syracuse gets their first down at the West Virginia 17-yard line with 8 minutes and 40 seconds left to play in the first half. Warner around the corner to the 15-yard line, pushed out of bounds by Lynn Murray.
I'll tell you again, you'll see Syracuse, good pressure inside from West Virginia. Warner does a good job just to get outside. Great block to see. Marty Chalk, if you saw that, did a great job of blocking, but Syracuse lucky to get outside at all.
Teddy Cirillo, number 71, brings the play in. Jimmy McAndrews comes out, and Syracuse has a 2nd and about 7 at the 15-yard line, just inside the 15. Split back. Joe Morris to the 12 or 13. There is a penalty flag on the field. play. Here comes the referee to tell us who was what. West Virginia was offside.
Again, that's the stunting look that they're giving. Again, Fultz and number 15. We'll see the play from nice low angle here.
Great ground level shot.
And you see Ziegler was down right there as Joe Morris cut off inside. Good block by number 61 for the Orangeman, Tony Hazen, the offensive guard.
Offside, defense.
Syracuse going to pick up a 3-5 yards. McAndrew's back in the game. McAndrew's had set up the play before. Got his bell rung, and he's going to replace Gordon Gronkowski. But Ziegler down. Ziegler seems to go down as much as Joe Morris. Joe always seems to make it back, but as we know, Ziegler lost two teeth against Penn State. And he took a real shot in the Boston College game, and he's down again.
He wants to get up, but Dr. Baker is telling him to stay still until we tell you to get up. From DeRuyter, nearby Syracuse, thank you, Joe. Obviously intended for Joe Morris, who's not only been a super athlete, but a superhuman being, and has just such enormous respect from the people of Central New York. All right, Ziegler being now allowed to sit up.
We'll take that in stages, you know. We'll make sure that you can sit up before you can get up, and then they'll let him take his time.
8:28 remaining. We're in the second period of play at the Carrier Dome. West Virginia leading 10-0. Now Ziegler's up. Looks a little woozy.
I think he got his bell rung.
Brett Ziegler, a sophomore from West Islip, Long Island.
Syracuse, the benefit of that penalty, now second and about 2.5.
Inside the 10-yard line. First down at about the 5.5 yard line, so it will be first and goal for Syracuse at the 5.5 yard line.
We'll see right here. They're taking away the outside. They're lining up basically in the 3-4 alignment. They don't have any defensive ends. The way they call them defensive ends, they're basically linebackers. They make Morris go up the middle. They're taking the outside away right away. They're pinching down both their outside people, taking it away, forcing Syracuse to attack the middle.
Syracuse sends in its straight tee offense, so they're going to try to hammer it in 5 yards out. Double tight end, straight tee formation. Warner will get to about the 4-yard line. Number 50, Folks. He just picked him up and body slammed him.
Yes, he did. Folks having a good game for West Virginia. A lot of hitting going on down there. We're going to have second and goal from about the 3.5 yard line.
You know where Folks is from? He's an Ohio Folks, Columbus, Ohio. That Woody Hayes wouldn't let him get away. From the 4-yard line, second and goal, straight tee offense. The fullback to about the 2-yard line, Jack Gilligan. They're trying to take it right to him. No fancy stuff, two plays in a row, just barrel straight ahead.
Well, as I said, they're taking the outside away. The Syracuse had the outside taken away. They've had some difficulty mounting a good offense. It's not a bad place to pass either. We'll see now. But the rollout pass is very difficult because they put a lot of pressure on the quarterback.
From the 2.5 yard line, third down. Gets to the 1-yard line. Those are tough yards. They started at the 5, then got to the 4, then to the 2.5. Now to the 1-yard line, where it is 4th and goal.
We'll see how tough those yards are up in there. Watch Joe Morris. You see Dave Warner come back, but tough yards. And right now, Syracuse appears to be going to go for the touchdown.
Virginia sends in every able-bodied giant.
And they try to throw them off sides here. And
look at all the big guys on the defensive line. Morris won't make it. He is stopped short. They just took all the big guys. They said everybody is 250 and over. Get into ball game and line up on the ball. And Syracuse tried to run it down their throats, and they stopped it.
Great replay. Fake to Gilligan. Gilligan up in the block. But good fill by the West Virginia Mountaineers, and Joe Morris comes up about a yard short.
5.5 minutes remaining. First half of play, West Virginia 10 to nothing. Syracuse's drive, ball short at the 1 yard line. They started at the 5, got to the 4, to the 2.5, to the 1, and then to the 1 again and ran out of bounds.
I think there might be some thought as to perhaps a field goal would have at least come up with something. They would have been back in the game. They can tie it up with a touchdown. As it is, the defense is not showing much of an ability to be able to stop West Virginia. Although they're certainly going to have a pretty good defensive field position to nose that ball resting just on the 2. Now you got to hope your defense can come up with another big play.
Hi, Mom. I love New York and the Syracuse University marching band. A crowd probably of, again, between 30 and 35,000, which will put Syracuse over 230,000 for 6 home games. The Mountaineers with their split backs lining up in the end zone. Conwell, the fullback, gets maybe a yard and a half.
Good
hit
penetration
by Pendock.
Yes, Pendock and Siebert. Pendock kind of a late addition. He's only a sophomore in a nearby Liverpool, and last week he's played before, but last week he played a great deal, did a good job pass rushing and stopping the run. He didn't start today, but he got in very, very quickly and is now back in there shoring up the middle. He's a big one, about 250-pounder.
Second down and 9. Luck lets it go downfield.
Good hit.
Incomplete. Derek Fredrickson, number 22, along with Kilpatrick, 19, Coban on the coverage. Pass was intended for Willie Drury, number 48.
And we'll see Luck drop back. Good pressure from Bingham. Hangs the ball up. Watch the hit here. There you go. That's the way to make sure the receiver isn't going to catch it. Good shot.
Less than 5 minutes remaining in the first half. 10-0 West Virginia. Mountaineers break the huddle. Line of scrimmage is the 3-yard line. Ibacks this time lined up in the end zone. Luck back to throw. No good. Intended for 88, Rich Hollins.
Well, that's the best Syracuse defense has looked. As we said, they had pretty good defensive field position as West Virginia was forced to go from their 2, pick up only 1, and they're going to be forced to punt from deep in their own end zone. Now, you don't know whether you want to put the block on or try to get a return on.
Well, I tell you, why not rush all 11 guys? Now they're going to drop 4 back, so they're rushing 7. They've got the return on. Don't put a lot of pressure on the punter. Coban at the 48-yard line. Good punt. Coban brings it back to around the 37 or 38.
Pretty good return. Good field position.
Yard punt, 12-yard return by Eddie Coban. And Syracuse has the ball at the 37-yard line in West Virginia territory. Lots of time remaining in the first half. 4 minutes and 41 seconds.
Syracuse, I think, has got to get on the board now. They want to feel that they can at least win at halftime and not be shut out. The offense has got to show the defense that they've come alive and take some pressure off. And right now, Coach McPherson sending some players, shuffling them in and out. Dave Warner's going to stop over on the sideline for a little chat with Coach Mack while we get a little bit of a timeout.
There are some 700 high school football players and coaches here today. Most of the high schools have finished their seasons, although the sectional playoffs are scheduled for the Carrier Dome on Sunday, the day after this ball game. There will be 4 Section 3 high school football playoff games at the Dome starting at noon on Sunday. In the Class D, that's the smallest school classification, it'll be Sequoyah Valley against Weedsport, followed by Herkimer High School against the Mackinac Heart of Watertown, and at 5 o'clock,
Holland Patton.
High school against Jamesville DeWitt. And then the Class A championship game, Rome Free Academy and West Genesee. That's scheduled for 8 o'clock Sunday evening here at the Carrier Dome. First and 10 from the 38-yard line.
Good play
to Willie Sidner, and he's down at the 15-yard line, hit by Lynn Murray.
There was no doubt about the way he delivered that ball. What I was talking about before, when he's taking away the outside, we'll see that there are a couple of possibilities. One is to run it up inside. The other is to do this, your quick passes, especially to decide where they've been sending the outside backer or the outside back. Syracuse hit Sidner on that big first down, right down to the 15 in about 2 seconds. So Syracuse offense, juiced up.
Morris to about the 12 or 13. Lynn Murray playing the other side this time, number two, covers Joe, who tried to cut and slip.
Well, they're taking away again that outside, and eventually Joe Morris is going to get one-on-one with one of those people on the perimeter. He's going to be able to cut it off. He only picked up about 2.5 on that particular play. Syracuse offense looks to be exploiting the defense. We'll see how they do on this play.
Morris brings it inside the 10 to maybe the 8-yard line. Syracuse needs the 5 for a first down. So they'll come up about 3 yards shy of it. Here comes number 58, Bobby Manning, into the ball game, replacing Jerry Ferry, 52, the starting junior offensive center.
Who that happens too often. Ferry is usually pretty tough. That's a big blow for Syracuse. When they're sending linebackers inside, you want to make sure you've got the best possible person in offensive center.
Third and 3. Syracuse needs to get to the 5-yard line. There's Dave Warner. He's got it. And a couple of more to about the 2-yard line.
Good offensive call. Warner turned up a little quicker than he has been. We'll see what he does. We've seen this play a couple of times before this year, quite a bit. Watch him turn up inside Gronkowski's block. Looks like he's going to the outside. He sets the linebackers up. They take a step to the left. He then cuts up inside. Gronkowski just buried his man. Warner picks up the first down.
Here come the big Giants defensively for West Virginia. Syracuse is going to show that double tight end straight T offense again.
West Virginia's going to show a timeout.
With 2:47 left to go in the first half and West Virginia leading 10 to nothing. Syracuse for the second time with a first and goal inside the 10-yard line. They came up short the first time, and we will find out right after the timeout whether or not they will be able to put some points up there this time. This is it for Syracuse this season. The next ball game for the Orange won't come until a year from now, when they will play opening game next season, Rutgers.
That'll be down in New Jersey, I believe.
Right, they'll open against Rutgers on the road.
We look now at the monitor, Carl. We see Syracuse offense picked up a little bit of steam there. 5 first downs now to West Virginia's 10. Obviously, West Virginia's offense dominating. But if they can punch one across here, they can come within 3. Tough to run down here, as you mentioned, Carl. They ran a nice pass play for an extra point against Maryland, where they dragged Marty Chalk across. Maybe we could see that play. We haven't seen it since Maryland, but tough going inside for Syracuse. Close.
Number 28 on the defensive play, that's Steve Newberry, who rides Glenn Moore down. Gain of maybe a half a yard.
Good pitch. Looked like it might make it. I thought he got face mask there, but, well, yes, he did, but that's all right. He didn't get in the end zone. Syracuse now forced to a second and about 2. They send Zambuto way out wide on the right-hand side. Watch, he was looking for Zambuto on the alley-oop pass that we saw in Pittsburgh. He just turns it up and dives inside. Yes, very close. Official right on it, gets the hands up in the air. Syracuse now down by only 10-6, and automatic comes in to kick the extra point. Extra point within three.
Well, he's got 69 straight over his career at Syracuse University, 19 for 19 this year, so he's looking to make it 70 in a row without a miss from the first one he kicked through right now. It's up and good, and it is 10-7. Gary Anderson now 20 for 20 this year and 70 straight. Well, he is, of course, a senior who will be tremendously missed next year.
Let's look at this touchdown. We'll see Warner's knee just about down. He dives through. The official feels he got his hand inside before his knee touched. That's going to give Syracuse 7 points. Interesting thing about that, he was looking for Zambuto on that alley-oop pass that we saw against Pittsburgh and kind of got a patent out of Zambuto, a great receiver, but he was covered very well. Zambuto did a good thing there, though we didn't see it in the replay, but he took the defensive back with him away from the corner and gave Warner the opportunity to turn up and only had two pursuers. Good heads-up play, both by Zambuto and Dave Warner.
Gary Anderson has 17 in a row.
Public address announcer Rick Wright announces to the crowd that Gary Anderson has now hit 70 consecutive point afters. He also is 40 out of 54 field goals, 16 out of 17 this year. 16 ties Dave Jacobs' single-season mark for field goals, so one more for Gary would give him a single season record. There's the kickoff. He hooks it out of bounds. 2:05 remaining in the opening half. It is now 10-7. What looked like there's going to be a blowout early in the ball game has now turned into a good close football game. Syracuse defense came alive and smothered the West Virginians the last two times they had the football. And the Syracuse offense, which wasn't able to make a first down through the first period, the last two times they had the football, were able to move it well.
Classic example of how the statistics don't always tell the story, because they were, Syracuse certainly out first downed in the beginning of that game and out hustled offensively. But when you only score 10 points and they can come back and get that one touchdown, and Syracuse did put them right back in the ball game, despite the fact that statistically the edge obviously would have to go to West Virginia.
Dave Warner gets the touchdown on a 2-yard run after a 6-play, 37-yard drive. Gary Anderson gets set to kick it off. This one goes into the end zone, even though it came from 5 yards farther back, and Drury gets it out to the 25-yard line. Coban is there, number 55, along with number 38, Rich Roach.
West Virginia a little better field position now. The last time they took over on about their own three, had to kick, and now they're, see the replay here of this run back. We see number 48 for the Mountaineers, Willie Drury, and we'll see Coban come into picture, number 5, and knock him out of bounds. Now we're back to live.
Oh, one-handed catch by Walczak. What a catch. Finally knocked out of bounds by Fredrickson and Coban.
Good screen.
Looked like there was a way in the world that Walczak was going to be able to catch that football, but he did.
The key on that screen is it happens so quickly, your defensive backs and linebackers don't have much of a chance to react. The ball is way out on the outside, and all he's got to do is run after he catches it. But you mentioned a great catch by Walczak. And West Virginia right back in business at their own 45.
Go deep.
Again,
quick draw play.
Gary Kilpatrick got him, number 19. Chris Hand reports into the Syracuse defense for Craig Bingham.
Bingham had bothered by injuries.
That's a shame, too. Craig Bingham, an outstanding football player, Tiger on defense, but he got hurt early in the season, and he has unfortunately been unable to perform 100%. Most of the season, and Syracuse sorely missed him. That'll get it down to about the 21-yard line, where the Mountaineers will have first and 10. 1 minute and 9 seconds remaining. First half of play, 10-7 West Virginia.
Big play for West Virginia as They don't stop the clock. Clock rolling. Oliver Luck going to throw a sideline pattern, and Ron Hobby drives out.
Billy Evans, the Billy receiver, Evans. Number three, and he's out of bounds in the neighborhood of the 15-yard line. Now it's back a little farther. Now just about the 15. They need to get to the 10-yard line. So it is second and short. Luck throws, complete, very close to the 10-yard line, which is what they need for a first down. Siebert and Coban on the tackle.
Good catch by Walczak, but I believe that's going to give West Virginia a first down. Nose of the ball resting just on the 10.
Down at the 10-yard line. 55 seconds left to play. There's
fumble.
A fumble.
And it'll be second down.
Bad snap or a bad transaction, I guess, is the way you describe it. But the quarterback, Luck, fell on it. So they waste the down, gain no yards, and lose some time on the clock. 40 seconds, and they stop it with 41 seconds remaining in the first half. West Virginia will have a second down at the 10-yard line, leading 10-7 over the Orange of Syracuse here at the Carrier Dome. Looking some more at the Syracuse schedule for next year, they'll open on the road against Rutgers on September 4th, then come home for Temple and Illinois, go out to Bloomington, Indiana to play the Hoosiers, come back to Maryland. Then on October 9th, Syracuse has an open date. We'll go to State College, Pennsylvania to meet the Nittany Lions on the 16th, then be home for three successive Saturday afternoon ball games. Pitt on October 23rd, Colgate on October 30th, Navy on the 6th of November, and then Syracuse will close on the road next year, Boston College and West Virginia in that order. The next event at the Carrier Dome, the four sectional high school championship ball games tomorrow, Sunday afternoon, beginning at noon, and then on Tuesday night, Syracuse basketball team will play an exhibition game against a team from Sapona, Yugoslavia. The regular season basketball opener for the Orange is the following Monday against the Red Raiders of Colgate. All right, Mountaineers break the huddle at the 10-yard line. 41 seconds left to go in the first half. Second down, open field to the left. Luck looking over the middle. He's got Walczak at the 5. Walczak gets to the 1-yard line. Clock moving, 30 seconds.
Syracuse going to get caught with too many men on the field here.
West Virginia without a huddle. Conwell gets to the goal line and in. With 19 seconds remaining in the first half, they go without a huddle and take it in for the 6 points to make it 16-7. Syracuse player hurt.
It might be Mike Jetbe.
Jetbe is the injured player.
Don't know whether or not they're going without the huddle had a significant effect, Dale, do you think, on the Syracuse defense?
Syracuse was trying to get in. They have a special defense they use for goal line situations, and they were half on the field and half off. As a matter of fact, I'm surprised they weren't called for having too many men in the field. Jerome Hall had just come on and was trying to replace one of the defensive backs. There was a mix-up. They ran the play, and by the time the Syracuse defense got organized, he was already across the goal line. I don't know if it would have made much difference on Syracuse's part.
Jetbe is the injured player. Clock stops with 19 seconds remaining. The West Virginia's getting ready to attempt the extra point, now leading 16-7. At the end of the first period, they led 10-0. Then Syracuse scored on a 2-yard run by Dave Warner and the 70th consecutive extra point by Gary Anderson to make it 10-7 just a minute and a half ago, and West Virginia has come back to score with 19 seconds remaining in the first half. Mike Jetbay coming off the field with two members of the Syracuse sports medicine staff.
That can be a big loss. He's got a broken thumb. I believe he's been playing with one, and that's tough. Good height.
Woodside gets that ball up quickly and high. And it is 17-7 with 19 seconds remaining in the opening half.
Syracuse going to have to a little more on the board offensively second half. We'll see the scoring plays. Eight plays, 75 yards, and a one-yard run. Syracuse set to receive with the Morris brothers, Mike and Joe.
Woodside, number six, who has missed a field goal, kicked one, and has two extra points, will kick it off to the Morris brothers. He is kicking it to Mike Morris, and Mike's going to bring it out of the end zone. And Mike is caught at the 20-yard line. Clock stops with 14 seconds left in the first half.
Syracuse want to play rather conservatively here, I would imagine. Go in down by 10 at halftime. Certainly not an insurmountable lead, but I think the defense, a couple of big plays in that last drive, that hurt Syracuse. Give Luck and company some open area in which to operate their offense completely, and in a lot of trouble. They're a good offensive football team now.
Joe Morris to the 35-yard line. Takes a big hit there, and he's a little slow getting up. About a 15-yard run by Joe. Clock stops with 8 seconds remaining in the first half.
Good blocking out front. He just cuts back. Good hit by number 47 from the Mountaineers. Zed Hughes, linebacker. And Joe comes to the sideline. We've seen it happen so many times before as recipient of many, many hits, Joe Morris.
Joe Morris with 11 carries and 43 yards so far. Oliver Luck having himself a heck of a first half. 17 for 21 and 175 yards. Mike Morris, number 36 in the offensive lineup for Syracuse, along with 44 Glenn Moore and 39 Jack Gilligan. So that'll be the backfield, along with Paul Zambuda, the other wide receiver, with Mike Morris. Let them both go and throw for six. There it goes. Mike Morris running under it. Can't hold on to it. At the 20-yard line. And that's the end of the first half. That kid was really smoking down the field. He ran away from those two defenders. Hope we can see how he pulls away. May not be able to. He pulled away from 15, who was trailing him, but picked up by 44. But 44 is the guy who knocked the ball away. That's Tim Agee. Number 15, Cedric King, was step for step with Mike, and then all of a sudden Mike turned it on and pulled 3 or 4 yards ahead of him, but he was picked up by the safety man, and he broke the play up.
Down, watch Oliver Luck, number 12, to Mark Rao in the end zone. Good catch by Rao. And now we'll see Dave Warner's touchdown run. Watch this. Very, very close. The referee called it good. He dives, just gets that ball inside the touchdown marker, giving Syracuse their touchdown. Gary Anderson kicked the extra point and made it 7-7, or excuse me, it's Syracuse 7 points. You can see just how close that was. Warner's ball just inside there. He's got that ball in his hand, just inside the marker.
You defend that goal, please turn your back to the goal.
Now we go back to
Syracuse will receive.
Second half.
West Virginia will defend this goal.
As the referee tells us that Syracuse will be receiving after having kicked off. Syracuse hoping to get a little bit more offensive fireworks. Carl, what do we got for first half stats?
The Mountain. Mountaineers with 20 more yards rushing, 65 to 45, 178 yards passing to 43 for the Orange, and 243 yards of total offense to 88 for Syracuse. The Orange had a punt three times, West Virginia once, and West Virginia lost the fumble for the first half's only turnover. Individual statistics. Joe Morris, 11 carries for 43 yards. Their leading ground gainer is Mickey Walczak, the junior for Saratoga Springs, 8 carries for 39 yards. Luck is 18 for 22 and 178 yards. Dave Warner, 3 for 5 and 43 yards. Willie Sittler has caught 2 passes and Brent Ziegler, 1. For the Mountaineers, Walczak is, in addition to being their leading ground gainer, 8 carries, 39 yards, is also their leading receiver, 6 catches and 49 yards. Mark Rao caught 1 pass, or 5 passes, 1 of 5 yards for a touchdown and 45 yards. Mountaineers penalized twice, Syracuse once. And I think it should be obvious to one and all, despite the fact that they knew they were going to the Peach Bowl, that the Mountaineers came to the Peach Bowl today. Mike Morris at the 2-yard line. Mike runs into big number 45 for the Mountaineers, Steve Hathaway, just shy of the 20-yard line. Well, he's going to give him just over the 20-yard line. He jammed him back to about the 18 or 19, but the officials spot the ball at the 21.
Morris, who was down on that kickoff, he's back up again, being escorted off the sideline. When his brother gets the ball, forces Joe to block, and at 5'7", 192 pounds, he's pretty big, but it's still a tough job taking on some of those people coming on downfield at top speed, and Joe jogs off. I'm sure we'll see him in this offensive series.
Glenn Moore, number 44, comes in to replace Joe as the tailback. Willie Sittner breaks the huddle, comes to the right side. He'll be wide to the right, and Paul Zambuto will be in the slot right. Glenn Moore, the tailback, and Jack Gilligan is the fullback. Tight end is to the left, the short side of the field. Warner's got some time, throws for Willie Sittner. Willie had to come back for the ball at about the 30-yard line and couldn't grab it. Don Stemple, number 35, on the coverage for the Mountaineers.
As you mentioned, pretty good coverage. In the half, West Virginia showed a real tendency to send those outside people, even sending their defensive backs on an outside rush to put pressure on. They didn't do it that time. Second and 10, we may see it this time. They put a lot of pressure on the outside of Syracuse's offensive line.
Same offensive set with Zambuto in the slot to the right and Sittner way out far right. Glenn Moore gets a couple, maybe the 22, 23-yard line. Covered by Folks, number 50. And that'll make it third and about 8. Syracuse needs to get to the 31-yard line. The ball is at the 23. Joe Morris comes back in, and Glenn Moore leaves the ball game. Early in the second half, with the Mountaineers leading 17-7. Syracuse has won 4 straight over West Virginia. Traffic. The pass is complete to Willie Sittner. He drew triple coverage on that play, still managed to make the catch.
And we'll see this catch by Willie Sittner, the transfer from Villanova. South Syracuse is passing so much this year, and we'll see it right here. Watch this diving catch. There's Sittner. Good coverage by number 44, AG, the defensive back, but not to be denied was Willie Sittner, giving Syracuse an important first down.
Now Sittner to the left and Zambuto to the right. Back to the pro set offense. Joe Morris on the pitch and he's tripped. And just gets back to the line of scrimmage. Number 35, Stemple, got a hand on his leg and upset him.
That's right. That play was about a foot from going for good yardage. A good block by Gilligan, but Stemple got his hand up, caused Joe to stumble. And Joe's got good balance. We saw in that highlight tape, and he didn't have it that time. And Syracuse now second and about 11.
Oh, corner to over the 45 to maybe the 47-yard line. Steve Hathaway and Tim Agee make the stop for the Mountaineers.
And Dave Warner, his last game as a senior, crushes up ahead and gives Syracuse a decent shot at a first down, third and a long three. And an important offensive series for the Orange.
Another great catch by Paul Zambuto, senior wide receiver from New Hyde Park, New York. Makes another one of those brilliant stretching, diving catches, and the Orange has a first down.
You know, Zambuto doesn't get a lot of ink around the East, and he really hasn't gotten the ball all that much, but every time he gets it, he seems to come up with a really good catch. Right there, a perfect example, Paul Zambuto, graduating senior. And again, a clutch first down for Syracuse.
Open field to Dave Warner's right, the near sideline. Joe Morris right up the middle of the 40-yard line.
Well, they're doing, West Virginia's continuing to do what they did in the first half, which is to send linebackers on occasion different areas up inside, and they'll also send the defensive backs from the outside, trying to confuse Syracuse offensive line. And one of the best ways is to go right at them. Syracuse did there, Joe Morris picking up about 3.5. Attempted to do it there, but Morris made a great cut, and he got some good blocking for a change to the outside. Read the blocking well and just turned it up. Joe Morris,
sophomore secondary man Tim Agee from Bethesda, Maryland, makes the stop for the Mountaineers, but Syracuse has a first down at the West Virginia 20-yard line.
Good cut by Joe Morris, set that play up, and good outside blocking.
Ziegler to the 15-yard line.
Ziegler looks like he's all ready to go again after getting up slowly. Watch Ziegler take this shot. Boom!
Eddie Hughes, 47,
Eddie
the guy
Hughes.
That hit him.
But I tell you what, you got to notice that Ziegler ended up going forward, ended up on his stomach after a tough hit. Credit Ziegler with a good, tough leg drive.
Hughes, another sophomore. He is from Ypsilanti, Michigan. To the 13 and maybe the 12-yard line.
Lynn Murray, defensive back, come up to get a hand on him. When they see Morris get that ball up, they just send a whole lot of people. Defensive backs, linebackers, they really collapse on him to the inside. Now is the time perhaps to get to the outside, have Warner keep the ball. We'll see what they do. The third and about 2.5, so they might not want to go too wide on this. Important third down play here.
Big split in the backfield. Warner rolling out to the left. Warner's gonna run. He's got room, and he probably has the first down. He needed the 10-yard line. He was hit at the 10. The referee looking over toward the marker at the far sideline. You know, from up here, you can see so easily when the quarterback ought to run and when he ought to try to throw it. And you can see that he had just about open field or a clear shot to get the first down.
Good point, Carl. It is easy up here, and they're going to get it right now. I think half a football.
And he got it.
Half a football. You make a good point there, though. It seems so easy, you can say cut it up now, but when you're down on the field and you're 6'1" and you're being chased by 6'3" people, it's very difficult to see all the alleys, the running alleys that we see up here. But Warner, again, turning it up. Good job, Dave Warner.
Just inside the 10-yard line, so Syracuse can't make a first down. First and goal from just inside the 10. Syracuse moving with the opening kickoff of the second half. Joe Morris to the 3-yard line.
The offensive line is blowing some holes in there. which they didn't do in the first half. Jerry Feary and company lollying Hazen. Nice block by Feary. The center sets that up.
Here comes Gilligan, 39, quickly into the Syracuse offensive backfield.
And as you mentioned, they cannot get a first down, and they're going to have the all big backfield in there. Zambuto a little bit late.
They better hurry up with 1 second left. Touchdown out of it.
Oh! I don't know. They weren't really... Apparently, the backs all know what they were going to do, but Zambuto didn't. Zambuto just went out and got position and said, apparently, I'm not going to get the ball. And they pitched the ball to Joe Morris. They ran it quickly. They saw the opening inside. Syracuse right back in this football game.
Syracuse took the opening second half kickoff.
Watch this pitch. Gilligan right out in front of him. Not much of a block, but... Number two, Lynn Murray, the defensive back, was out of position, and Syracuse in for the score.
Control the ball for 5 minutes and 40 seconds and scored the touchdown. Extra point is good, 17 to 14.
Well, now that Syracuse defense has got a lot to be happy about, the offense responded and did their job. Syracuse defense has got to come back and stop that big play.
You know, it's interesting, Dan, you talk about strategy and carefully laid out plans, and then you go in to a play like that where they had Gilligan come in and Ziegler wasn't sure whether he should come out or not. Zambuto was out of the huddle, didn't know the play, and there's the snap, and you get a touchdown out of it.
Give them credit anyway. Zambuto decided that apparently I just better get in my position, because if I don't know what's going on, apparently I'm not supposed to. Did what he was supposed to do, which is have the safety come over, the corner come over and play him one-on-one, and then Morris just took the ball up inside. Nice pitch.
What you're supposed to do is knock down the guys that are trying to tackle the guy with the ball. If everybody does that, it doesn't matter what play you call.
That's right. Syracuse offense seemed to pick up a lot of momentum. Very, very excited about that last play. And the play calling, it seems to me that the Syracuse offense a little bit more deliberate. I think they found some things from their spotters. As we look at the scoring drive, 13 plays, 79 yards, culminated by that 2-yard dive by Morris. But I think the Syracuse scouts up in the top of the dome here found some areas they think they can attack on this West Virginia defense. Picks it up well. There's Joe Morris, 12th leading rusher in NCAA history, driving for more.
Joe Morris, his 10th touchdown of the season. Dave Warner's earlier was his 7th of the campaign. And Drury will not bring it out. Gary Anderson, the senior from Downingtown, Pennsylvania, no doubt but what he will be a pro draft choice. He gets the ball off quickly, gets it up high. He has fantastic accuracy, a very strong leg. The Buffalo Bills have had a scout here at every game this season watching Morris or rather Anderson for about a half hour before the game with a stopwatch, clocking everything he does. Jette on the stop of Rao, and a pickup just short of 10 yards, a 9-yard gain, so it'll be second down and one for the Mountaineers. The guy with the... Now, maybe he's not in the Buffalo Bills. You know, all this clandestine stuff. He's got a Buffalo Bills T-shirt on. He wears a Buffalo Bills jacket. And he's been here at every home game, and he's in the stands very early when Gary Anderson comes out. And he's always got the stopwatch.
I'm sure they're looking at a lot of people, a lot of scouts sent out. Incidentally, Carl, we're getting a discussion on the field. Apparently, there was an ineligible receiver downfield on that last play, and that could cost West Virginia a bit, and we'll see if that's what it is.
Tony Romano now coming to the sideline to talk to Coach Dick McPherson. Explain to the coach exactly what the official told him.
And we'll hear
you. We had an ineligible downfield. He touched the ball. The captain elected to take a 5-yard penalty and the loss of down.
That's the important thing, yeah.
Second down.
Loss of down now, so it will be second down plus the penalty, 5 yards. So it's second and 15. Big break for the Syracuse defense.
his tight end, Mark Rao. Romano, 54, 19, Kilpatrick hit him. And the play gains about 7 yards. Now that'll make it third and about 7 or 8. They had a second and 15, and they picked up about half of it on that pass completion. So it's third and 7 or 8. They have to get to the 30-yard line for a first down. Pass is complete at the 29-yard line. Zunick makes the stop at the 29. Walczyk was the pass receiver, and it is short by about a yard.
And we'll see Oliver Luck, I don't think, wanted to go to Walczyk. He pumped twice. I think he was waiting for Walczyk to clear the linebacker. And Zunick makes a good tackle, saving that first down attempt.
Jody McCollum, number 21, is the punter. Fair catch by Willie Sidner at the 38-yard line, and the Orange offense has the football back.
That's one of those, shoot, that was very close to being a first down. I like Oliver Luck, and I like the way he throws the ball. They use their whole offense very, very well. Their backs have to be very good receivers to play for West Virginia because they're the recipients of numerous passes. But at the time, they came up a little short. Syracuse, of course, a big break on the ineligible receiver downfield. Got not only the 5-yard penalty, but the extra down, so now's the time to take advantage of it.
34-yard punt.
Sure knows that.
And a fair catch by Sidner. No return, and the ball is at the 38-yard line, where it will be first and 10 for Syracuse, trailing 17-14 with 7:49 remaining in the third period. West Virginia led 10-0 at the end of the first period, 17-7 at halftime, and it's now 17-14 as the Mountaineers, headed for the Peach Bowl, try to snap a Syracuse four-game winning streak over them. Syracuse won in 77, 78, 79, and last year. Mountaineers' last victory was in 76, 34-28. These teams score a lot of points when they play each other. Syracuse will play down at Morgantown in the season finale next year. Football starts again at noon at the Carrier Dome on Sunday with Sequoyah Valley and Wheatsport in the Class D New York State Section 3 High School Championship game. Then Herkimer plays Immaculate Heart of Watertown, Colin Patton against Gainesville DeWitt, and Rome Free Academy against West Genesee for the Class A title. One setback, slot right. Ziegler, the only setback, gets across the 40 to the 42-yard line. That's about a 5-yard pickup.
Good blocking up front again. Well, they slotted Sidner to this side, split Sam Buter to the left, and just gave the ball, as you said, the last remaining setback, and Ziegler drove ahead for a good 4 yards. That's the kind of offense you'd like to see here. Some time-consuming and hold on to the football.
Ziegler made a valiant effort at picking that one up before it hit the turf.
You hate to see those go up in the air because they can always go anyway. Ziegler did make an attempt, but Syracuse appearing to be in a little bit of trouble there had that ball been intercepted.
Mark Eady, number 74, brings the play in as Jimmy McAndrews comes out along the offensive line for Syracuse. Syracuse is going to have a tremendous job rebuilding their offensive line for next year. The only returners are the tight end, Marty Chalk, and the center, Jerry Fury. Everybody else graduates. Joe Morris,
inside reverse.
On an inside reverse, right, the old maybe Ben Schwartzwalder scissors play. Saw Benny at halftime. Ben, of course, is a West Virginia graduate. He was an offensive center at the University of West Virginia when he played his football there, and there was always a great feeling of intense rivalry when Syracuse and West Virginia played during the time that Coach Schwartzwalder was at the helm of the Orange. That's what Benny used to call the scissors play, inside reverse. It lost a couple of yards, and it is fourth down, and Joe Ross is in the punt. It's a beauty off. And it will be downed, I believe, by Jerome Hall at the 5-yard line.
Good heads-up play. That ball bounced up in the air. Jerome Hall, a freshman, downed it very smartly right on the 5-yard line, puts West Virginia to Hall.
A 56-yard punt. Joe Ross has got 2 for 54, 1 for 56, and a 38-yard punt today. Ball is actually spotted inside the 5-yard line. First and 10 for the Mountaineers. 6.5 minutes remaining, third period. 17-14, West Virginia by 3. Oliver Luck throwing from the end zone. Hits his tight end, Mark Rowe. Jerry Kilpatrick rolls him out at about the 16-yard line.
He must be averaging close to 10 yards a play on first down. They always seem to come up with that big play, and Rowe, the favorite target, big tight end, good catch, and that gets them right out of that hole that Jerome Hall put them in when he downed the ball on the 5. So right about the 16-yard line, Carl.
For Rowe, that is his 7th reception, giving him 58 for the year. Walczak on first down takes it straight ahead for a couple of yards.
Blaze winner number 98 for Syracuse, doing a good job. He's one of those people who was hurt a little bit earlier in the year, had a bad thigh injury, but come back and doing a good job, playing a lot for them. Blaze winner out of Bloemfield, New York.
Second and long for the Mountaineers. 5:54 left in the third period. Wide to the near sideline. Obvious passing situation for Luck. Over the middle of Walczak, hit by Romano and Zunick.
They use that play all the time to Walczak out of the backfield.
That's going to be short by a yard or a yard and a half of a Mountaineer first down. So it'll be third and a long one for the Mountaineers.
Perhaps a draw play. See what formation they line up in. Gotta watch out for the draw.
Walczak has the first down to the 29-yard line. Stopped by Romano, Coban.
It was a good play, Colley. Use that draw, let the tailback read the blocking, and they've been passing so often. Tough to be aware of that.
Two wide receivers to the far sideline this time for the Mountaineers. Luck looking that way. Then drops one off to his tight end, Rowe, who is tackled at the 35-yard line by Romano and Siebert. Reception number 8 for Rowe. Completion number 22 out of 27 for Oliver Luck and 220 yards. About a 6-yard pickup, second down and 4 for the Mountaineers. Wide receivers this time to the near sideline, 2 of them. On the delay to Walczak, and Walczak is to the 37-yard line. Hit by Blaze Winter, 98, Jet Bay, 94.
Third down.
This is a big third down again. Last time they went with the draw play, that little delay. Gotta watch Walczak out of the backfield, out of the tailback position.
Jette catches up with Rao, but it is a Mountaineer first down near midfield.
We'll see. Luck looks at Rao. We'll see. Rao comes across against that Syracuse defense in under coverage. The linebacker's got to pick up that tight end, make the tackle, but they have trouble preventing the pass. And Luck, good athlete that he is, put that ball right in there, and Rao has pulled him out again. Another first down for West Virginia.
Rao with 9 receptions, and he's picked up 84 yards. Walczak hit by Romano at the 45-yard line. It'll be a gain of about 3 yards.
Carl, I was just going to say the pressure really isn't coming now on Oliver Luck. And if his primary receivers are covered, he's going to hit Walczak all day. Walczak's got to be one of the leading receivers on the team as he's picked up pass after pass when the primary receivers are covered.
Walczak has 8 receptions for 63 yards. Rao with 9 for 84. And Luck is now 24 out of 29 for 238 yards. 2:27 left, third period. West Virginia 17-14. They have a second and 7. From the Syracuse 45-yard line. Out of bounds when he caught it. 88, Rich Hollins was the receiver, but no reception. Out of bounds on the catch, and it will be 3rd and 7 now for the Mountaineers.
And in this drive, they've shown an amazing ability to pick up that third down, although each third down has gotten successfully longer, and this is going to be the longest third down play of this drive. And they've shown a real ability to come up with that big play. We'll see what Coach Nealon comes up with now. 3rd and about 7. That ball was tipped no less than 2 or 3 times before number 22 for Syracuse. Derek Fredrickson came up with the interception. We'll watch right here.
Watch the hit that makes him throw it poorly.
He just set up now. Blaze Winter.
Blaze Winter, number 98, hits him. It is tipped by Hobby. Almost caught again and then grabbed by Derek Fredrickson.
Big break for Syracuse, but I'll tell you what, that wasn't really a break because Blaze Winter caused that break to happen. He was hurt earlier in the year. He's a big kid, 6'3", 249 pounds. He's only a sophomore. Had a very, very badly bruised thigh when they started preseason. Apparently, he's healed. I talked to Coach McPherson. They had expected big things out of him. But as always, you have to contend with injuries, and he was an early casualty. But he showed no signs of a bad thigh or a bad wheel on that play as he put a lot of pressure on Oliver Luck.
Dave Warner is 5 out of 9 for 70 yards. Dave already holds a single season attempts and completion records for Syracuse. Starting the ball game, he needed 116 yards to set a new record for single season yardage. He is up to 70 yards now, so he's about 46 yards short of that at this point. With a minute and 59 seconds remaining, third period. Syracuse with the ball at their own 35. One up to Willie Sidner. Sidner, yes, grabs it and holds on at the 30-yard line.
He outjumped Tim Agee, a defensive back. That's just a question of, I'm going to hang it up, and let's see who can go up and come down with it. And here it is right on the replay. Good pressure from the outside. Warner doesn't even see it coming. He does get the ball off, but watch this. This is just a basketball pass. Good body position. See, Sidner got in front of him, up in the air, holds on to the ball. And we'll see it in another angle. You see how that ball just got off in time. Sidner, beautiful body position and a great catch.
From the 30-yard line, Ziegler in motion toward the far sideline. Warner with a late pitch to Joe Morris. Joe is going to go all the way. Nobody can catch him.
You know who made that play? Number 17, Paul Zambuto, ran a defensive back all the way into the end zone. They pitched the Morris. There was nobody there. It was all over but the shouting.
Joe Morris with his second touchdown of the ball game and his 11th of the season. A 30-yard touchdown run by the senior captain from Ayer, Massachusetts. Syracuse's all-time leading ground gainer.
We'll see this on the replay.
Warren has taken the lead.
We'll see the pitch right there. Paul Zambuto, we'll see him come in, number 17. He's run the safety man off. We never see it. Great run by Joe Morris, but a beautiful job of faking by Zambuto. What a play.
For 22 this season and 72 in a row for Gary Anderson, and it's now 21-17.
Look, see it right here. Watch Morris. There's nobody there to beat. Watch. You see Zambuto right there in the screen is running off the safety. He never sees Joe Morris get the ball on the pitch. Joe Morris walks in the end zone. Here we see Dave Warner.
now, incidentally, with 6 out of 10, 105 yards, so he is 11 yards away from setting a single-season yardage record. Joe Morris with 19 carries, 103 yards. In his freshman year, Joe carried the ball 16 times for 99 yards against the Mountaineers. In 79, 20 times for 166 yards, and Joe was hurt and didn't play against West Virginia last year. This is Joe Morris's 21st game over 100 yards. Here's Anderson's kickoff. High and deep. Almost out of the end zone. And the Mountaineers will put it in play at the 20. First and 10. A minute and 27 seconds remaining in the third period. 21-17. Syracuse by 4 over West Virginia.
Continuing to show themselves the second half team, Carl. A real good comeback offensively, and that pass interception, the key set it all up, and it was all set up by number 98, Blaze Winter, who put the pressure on Locke and made him get rid of it early.
Syracuse's touchdowns have been 2 yards each for Joe Morris and Dave Warner, and a 20-yard run by Joe Morris. So Morris has got 2 touchdowns, and Warner 1, all on the ground. Pass is complete to the 40-yard line. Fredrickson makes the tackle there.
Boy, West Virginia just comes right back and throws that football. Nice grab by Wayne Brown, a wide receiver. Boy, I tell you, they eat up yards quickly. You have them in a hole on the 20, now they're out at their own 41-yard line in about 2 seconds flat.
First and 10 from the 41. Luck straight back. He's hit. Intercepted by Tippey.
Well, you got to give Chris Hand credit on that. He should get a half an assist. Number 89, defensive tackle, put the pressure on Luck. Let's see it on the replay. Here's Luck. Now just starts to set up. Primary receiver hasn't broken fast as man yet. Watch 89. Chris Hand right there. A different angle, and just gets by his man.
He just runs over the guy.
Just ran right over him.
There was no way he was going to keep Chris Hand away from the quarterback. No way.
A lot of desire.
Well, that's what Nealon said again, talking before the ball game. Attitude is so critically important. He said that these kids just don't know that they're not a very good football team. It was a question of attitude and desire on that play.
Sidner
again. Willie Sidner at the 21-yard line.
And there's a flag down, and they're going to call holding, I think. John McCollum, hot, number 79, the offensive tackle. And Willie Sidner down, out of bounds after that great catch.
Final minute of the third period, 59 seconds left in the third period, as Sidner gets hit inbounds. Here's the referee to explain what happened.
We have an ineligible lineman, downfield, offense, first down.
That's the second call like that in this ballgame, ineligible receiver downfield. It's a penalty plus a loss of down.
Should cost the down. They haven't put it on the down marker that way yet. Down, so
it is a loss of down, though, isn't it?
Well, that's what they called the first time. Perhaps a slightly different interpretation. Guess it doesn't make a lot of difference.
That's the way to get it back.
And there's going to be another flag down, and I think that Joe Morris got KO'd. We'll see what happens. Watch this. Good blocking to the outside. Morris just sprints. I'll tell you, I'm sure the coaches are calling these from up top because they're spotting the weaknesses. And on the top of this, we're going to get another 15. We'll see at the end of this run. Watch Joe Morris get his face mask rolled. Good blocking by Lolly. Zambuto blocking very well downfield. And there goes Morris, and there's the face mask right there. And that's going to pick up another 15 for Syracuse. That's going to Kyle?
I think we have seen here in the second half, or at least the third period so far, Dale,
personal foul,
the difference between
face mask and force at the end of the run.
Sheer determination and attitude. This team has come out in the second half and at this point has refused to even consider losing this football game. Close to the 10-yard line.
Well, I'll say there's a lot of hitting going on. There's a lot of pushing and shoving after the play, too. I think West Virginia thinks, hey, we thought we had this bowl game in the bag. We can't let down now. And Syracuse is really pushing for this win. And there's a lot of heavy hitting going on in the trenches.
Time will run out in the third period, and it does.
And I'll tell you what, this is a typical pattern of the Syracuse game. The first half, let's be candid, it's a bit boring, right? Now you see what happens. Everybody's on their feet the second half. Syracuse comes back. It's an exciting football game.
I think all the people in the stadium have recognized that this has been one of the most determined and courageous efforts by a Syracuse football team in a couple of years. These kids have just refused to consider not winning this football game, and they have made up for what they lack, perhaps, in speed and in size and in ability.
You mentioned what
by sheer courage.
Said. That's right, and he said this football team, they didn't know that they weren't perhaps as talented as the record indicates. I think that Syracuse is sort of the same thing. They're not an overly talented football team. They've got some talented individuals, but they're trying to put it together today, and now they're 21-17 and hoping to add 7 points.
They're playing with enthusiasm. Remember what, I've forgotten now who it was. It was Yogi Berra, and I think he was talking about baseball. But the same could apply here, where he said, you know, half of this game is 90% mental. I'm sure you know what he meant.
However, well, we do have 15 minutes left, and I think Yogi Berra also said it ain't over to the fat lady sings.
Now, we have, you might think we've already put it in the win column. We haven't. But this has been a very courageous third period by Syracuse, regardless of what happens the rest of the way.
Look at it rather rationally. I think the offense has been clicking. The play calling has been, instead of sort of just general plays to see what happens, they seem to have a real idea of what weaknesses they can exploit in the West Virginia defense. And as a result, I think the play calling has been magnificent so far this third quarter. And you know, that holding penalty on McCollum, or I assume it was on McCollum, he was the one that complained, number 79, was wiped out in an instant when Joe Morris got the ball.
Well, he didn't call it holding. He called it
downfield,
but that is a loss of down. However, I'm sure we'll all get it explained later on. Syracuse catching up statistically, too. Syracuse with 159 yards rushing, 105 passing, 264 in total offense to this point. The Mountaineers 327 in total offense.
It might be a little added incentive as this game, as you mentioned before, is being originally telecast as the local game of the week. And Syracuse going to be on the East Coast.
And the first half, West Virginia had through halftime 243 yards in total offense. They're up to 327 now. About 80 yards in the third period. Syracuse went from 88 yards to 264. That's about 180 yards in the third period. All right, here we go. Opening play of the fourth quarter. Dave Warner kept his balance and brought the ball down to the 7-yard line. Some of the West Virginia kids asking the referee whether or not his knee didn't touch somewhere back there, and the referee says it didn't.
Watch the stumble here. It reminds me of Joe Morris's run last week. Watch him go down. He doesn't touch. His hand goes down. He's not down till his knee's down, and a good carry by Dave Warner. Bring up third and about three. And this is very important now. This first down, crucial.
Third and three. Morris to the 5-yard line. It looks like he'll come up a couple inches short.
It looked for a moment like that hole was going to stay open, but it didn't, and they're going to see Gary Anderson come in.
Anderson to attempt what would be his 17th field goal of the season, which would give him the record for the number of field goals in a single season held by Dave Jacobs and Anderson, now at 16. This will be number 17. And it is. And that makes it 24-17. Syracuse now with a 7-point lead and 13 minutes and 43 seconds to go. Gary Anderson now 17 out of 18 this year, 41 out of 55 career.
Well, it's character time right now for both teams. West Virginia is down only one touchdown. They've had a lot of momentum taken away from them. Syracuse didn't come up with a touchdown. They come up with three. They're ahead by seven. They've got to really get tough defensively. They've come up with two big turnovers this second half, intercepted passes, and they've got to do it again if they want to win this football game, because I don't think they can do it with just 7 points. I think they got to get another field goal or a touchdown to really ice it.
Right now, we would be looking at a West Virginia touchdown and a decision then for one or two extra points. No question, I guess, but what they would go for the two and the win. Gary Anderson getting set to kick it off from the 40-yard line. He has put every one of them into the end zone.
Boy, he won 35 when he had kicked the first one out of bounds.
He is going to be very difficult to replace. I wonder where Dom McCauley from Long Island is going to go to school. 53-yard field goal for a high school kid. Of course, we don't know that he's a senior. Is that a ball?
A little bit of noise, yeah. A little bit of noise in here. I don't think they can hear the whistle. Didn't seem to bother Anderson any.
That was almost up in the stands. No question, Dale, you made the observation early in the second half that Syracuse's offense was juiced up. No question but what all the fans and the offense and the defense are juiced up.
Well, here it is right now. The fans are going to be a little quiet. The offense doesn't have the ball. Now the defense has got to do it on their own. And this first down play has been very, very good for West Virginia. I think they've been averaging about 10 or 12 yards on first down.
Walzak gets about 2 yards.
Right, that little delay to Walzak, that draw, and Syracuse up to stop that for one of the few times they've been able to read it and put a really good hit on Walzak. And Chet Bain, Siebert check out. We get a lot of personnel shuffling to Syracuse on different downs, and strategy, of course, not known to us right now, but certainly doing all they can to stop this West Virginia team.
Four down linemen up front. They're all after Luck. He floats one down the middle. He's got somebody wide open at the 45, to the 40, to the 35. Hobby after him and catches him inside the 25. That's 88, Rich Collins.
That's the big play they had to stop. Luck got a lot of time. Good amount of time to throw the ball, and he can really fire. And we'll see Hollins right there behind. Now that's Mike Zunick, 48, a linebacker, and that's tough coverage for him. You got to think a safety should have been up there a little bit tighter, because Zunick has not got enough speed to cover a wide. Good saving tackle by Hobby.
Rao is hit by Romano, juggles the football, and then drops it. Luck was under a lot of pressure then, too. Luck is now 26 out of 35, 316 yards.
But importantly, too, he has two interceptions, which were costly. We'll see a good hit here by Romano, making sure that that ball stayed an incompletion.
Hit first by Kilpatrick and then by Blaze Winter, number 98. So they just get back a yard or so
They've had good success in that play. They tried a quick screen. The man on Kilpatrick, and I didn't catch his number, missed the block, and Kilpatrick slowed him up until help came along, and that was a big play by Kilpatrick.
Third down and nine. It is caught by number 83, Jim Kaser, who is in as the second tight end, K-A-S-E-R, Jim Kaser. That makes Luck now 28 out of 36 for 327 yards. Here comes Rao back in, and Kaser, who caught that pass, goes out. The ball is at the 10-yard line, and it appears to be just outside the 10, so the Mountaineers could pick up a first down. First and 10 from just behind the 10-yard line. Luck to Walczak. Walczak out of bounds at the 7-yard line. Written out by Siebert.
I'll tell you, I think Oliver Luck could have run that football for a little bit more yardage than he got there, but he looked like he was all alone.
Walczak, the youngster from Saratoga Springs, having himself a big day. He's got 44 yards on the ground in 12 carries, 9 pass receptions for 72 yards.
He's a heck of a pass receiver. Good half.
11 minutes remaining in the ball game. Luck throws it behind his intended receiver, Rao. Both Fredrickson and Kilpatrick were there on the coverage.
Decent rush by Charles and Blaze Winter. Mike Charles and Blaze Winter, the inside rushes for Syracuse. But Luck just threw the ball behind. Going to bring up now third. Very, very close. I guess they'd almost have to score in order to get a first down. It's that close.
Play brought in by number 19, Wade Brown, wide receiver. Zone for a touchdown by Brown, who brought the play in. The coverage was there. It was one-on-one. He just caught the ball.
Hey, that's the way it goes. It was good coverage. Kilpatrick just got beat a little bit. The advantage is with the offensive player. You watch. Luck looks left. Now he comes right. Good pressure by Butsky, but a nice catch. And Kilpatrick there just a little bit behind him. Wayne Brown, the freshman from Somerville, New Jersey. Good catch.
All right, they're going to go for one extra point. There's plenty of time left, so they will go, it appears, for one to tie it up. That's what they do, and it's up very high. Perfect. And it is 24 apiece.
Pressure now swings back to the offense, and when you got a game tied like this, it's going to go back and forth. Every time the offense gets the ball, the pressure's going to be on them. Every time the defense, if they have any kind of a lead, they can kind of take a little bit of a breather one way or the other, but in a game this tight,
that took some of the pressure off Don Nealon, having to decide whether to go for one or two extra points. Although I guess the day of coaches going for ties anymore is long gone. That used to be. I guess nobody's done it since the Notre Dame Michigan State
1966.
Game. Yeah. Because of all the furor that created, I don't think any coach plays for a tie anymore. Because if he goes for the win and makes it, everybody's delirious, and if he goes for the win and doesn't make it, everybody says, well, at least he went for the win. He wasn't satisfied with the tie. So you can't lose by going for the win, I guess. Even if you lose, you win. Huh. 24 apiece and lots of time. 11 minutes remaining in the ball game.
I'd like to see Joe Morris field this.
Joe hasn't had a chance to return a kickoff in this ball game. His brother's gotten all of them.
You get a look at, before this kickoff, the 8-play, 79-yard drive, and then that Oliver Luck to Brown touchdown.
Luck is now unofficially 30 out of 39 for 345 yards. Joe Morris lets it go through the end zone.
Well, we might have seen Joe have a chance to show his kickoff form, but Syracuse is going to be the recipients of that ball right at their own 20-yard line, and the offense, again, got to get right to work early.
was.
Syracuse fan apparently got a West Virginia banner and tries to get the crowd excited again as the offense is going to have to go to work.
Exciting, colorful, intercollegiate football. We were delighted on WCNY TV to be able to bring it your way statewide. And again, we'd like to ask you, please, if you enjoyed intercollegiate football on public television this season, to write to us at WCNY TV, Old Liverpool Road, Liverpool, New York, 13088. Let us know so that we can use that as evidence to convince folks that we ought to do it again next year. To all of you who have written, thank you very much. Morris to about the 30-yard line. Syracuse needed the 30 for the first down. Joe was down at the 30. The referee taking a look over at the far sideline.
That's going to be very close. They're going to have to measure.
No, he says it's a first down.
I guess you made a liar out of me. Syracuse offense starting out the same way they did before, with Ziegler getting a quick four and then seeing if they can't exploit some of these weaknesses of the West Virginia defense. Took to the outside the last time they had the ball with Joe Morris on an option. Well, there we see it again.
Joe to the 35-yard line.
Nice block downfield by Willie Sidner, but
good hit by 24, Reggie Armstead, too. 9:47 left to play. The game is tied at 24.
Armstead came up along with AG and helped stop Joe Morris, but he picked up. Well, he's down again. Joe down on the outside. Ooh, kind of a, see kind of hit Joe takes here, Carl. We'll see the pitch, and we'll see Joe right there, number 44. That's AG.
And number 24, Armstead.
Armstead tries to take his head off.
Glenn Moore getting set to come in. In fact, he does come in, the Syracuse offensive backfield. Joe being helped up over across the way. Stepping gingerly on one of his legs.
Think he'll be back?
Well, he's going to get a standing ovation whether he comes back or not.
I think he'll be back. He's a tough kid, and he's been a great help to Syracuse University and Central New York community in general. Quite an athlete, quite a young man, and we see right there, watch the pitch. This was the same play that Joe scored on. When AG comes up and puts a lick on him along with Harnstead. So there's the Dome Ranger.
We'll be seeing plenty of him during basketball season, too.
I always wonder who paid for his tickets. He must be independently wealthy.
Well, yeah, we're going to do it. There we are.
If he uses that gun. All right, Glenn Moore is the tailback. Brent Ziegler is the fullback. Dave Warner, the quarterback. The pitch to Glenn Moore. Nice cutback by Moore. He's to the 40, maybe 41-yard line.
I was just going to say, Glenn Moore's not too shabby a replacement for Joe Morris. Played behind Joe, of course, for the last couple of years, but Glenn Moore, tough kid, and we'll see you right here.
Tell you what you'd like to do right now, Dale, is to keep this ball for the next 9 minutes and 14 seconds and score on the last play of the game.
Absolutely, and the sophomore at Deptford, New Jersey, shows that he's going to be more than an adequate replacement for Joe Morris next year.
Okay, that time, so it'll be second and 10 for Syracuse. Less than 9 minutes remaining now.
Good penetration.
And West Virginia tied at 24.
Excuse me, Carl, I'm just going to say, Darryl Talley, good pursuit. And we'll get a look at Joe Morris sitting on a bench being looked at by the trainers. Doesn't appear to be in a great deal of pain. Said it was going to be a very emotional game for him, and I'm sure that the orange staff would like to see him back in.
It didn't work. Look out, there is some wrestling and pushing in there. Folks and Fury 50 and 52. But they break it up quickly, and the boys exchange slaps on the fanny, and it is all forgotten very quickly.
Hung this one up. It was the same play that Sidner took away from West Virginia before. Same type of a pattern, but Sam Butel got his pocket picked there by number 28, Steve Newberry. It certainly wasn't Sam Butel's fault. Newberry in a good position got the ball.
Warner with one interception, 6 out of 11, 105 yards.
Now this first down play, very important. Mention again that West Virginia's had very, very good luck, shall we say, on first down. They've managed to, except for the last series when they only got about 3 or 4 yards, they've had good luck and it gives them good field position.
Syracuse and West Virginia have never played a tie ball game. Syracuse leads the series 17 to 11. In 63, it was 15 to 13. In 1969, West Virginia won 13 to 10. In 1975, Syracuse won 20 to 19. The Mountaineers and Syracuse played for the first time in 1945 and have played almost every year since. And West Virginia remains on the Syracuse schedule into the foreseeable future. And a good rivalry. It started just before Coach Fortwalter came to Syracuse. It started in 45, and they played in 56. 45, 46, and skipped to 55, and 55 on, and pretty much every year. Stopped after about a two-yard gain.
Kilpatrick and Ruff came up and really, really put the hit on Walzak, and he picks up about 2.5 yards on that. Again, now second down. Every second down, Syracuse seems to be changing defenders. Jet Bade takes a rest, and Mike Zunick, number 48, replaces him as linebacker for the Orange.
Again, Kilpatrick, 19, was there on the coverage, one-on-one with Rao, and Rao makes the catch.
Good catch. Again, you can't really fault the coverage if Syracuse defenders are that close on every passing down. They'll have a good defense, but cut him with a good catch and a good pass. Still third down.
Third and less than a yard. I think he got it. He didn't get very much more than half a yard, but I think he got what he needed.
Tackled by Pendock and Jetbay.
That was Conwell, the fullback. He's only carried the ball 8 times. He's gained 19 yards, but he got enough that time for the first down.
Again, now time becomes a factor. West Virginia likes to, of course, use as much time as possible on this drive. They're on their own 30. They've got about 7 minutes left to go in this fourth quarter in the game. Syracuse defense got to hope they can get the ball back.
What an effort by Guy Ruff. He tipped it and caught it himself. Guy Ruff on the interception.
Senior out of Windham, Ohio, and comes up with an important interception. One of those seniors graduating this year.
Syracuse, their 12th interception of the season, and number one for Guy Ruff.
And 3 for this game. know, it's interesting, Carl. They talk about the maligned secondary. You'll notice that one of the leading receivers on a lot of the teams that come in here have been the backs out of the backfield. So not all the time. The secondary takes quite a rap, and I don't think it's always necessarily their fault. Some under coverage can really help. And right there, Guy Ruff, heck of a job. Big interception. Syracuse got the ball on the 46-yard line with 46 left to go. And there's a happy Guy Ruff. Windham, Ohio. Joe Morris, of course, is back. I've tuned up again. We've seen him in and out so many times this year. You can't hold him down. I think you'd have to cut him up with a knife to get him to stop.
Joe with 24 carries and 147 yards and two touchdowns in this ball game. Dave Warner has the other touchdown. Warner and Morris with 2 yard touchdown runs each, and Joe with a 20 yard touchdown run. Now we can go back to where we were before. Score on the last play of the game. Not yet, Joe. It's too early.
Nice block by Brent Ziegler, number 43. Defensive end, the linebackers come right across. Watch, they'll try to take the outside away, and we'll see the block right there by Ziegler. You don't see it, but he did make the block, didn't cut him out, but did knock him out of the hole. That allows Joe to shoot up there rather quickly and give Syracuse a big first down on the 33-yard line.
6.5 minutes remaining. Glenn Moore back into the tailback spot. Joe Moore goes to the sideline for a rest. Line. The pitch to Moore. Nice block by Ziegler. Moore gets to the 30 and maybe the 29. That'll be a 3 yard pickup.
They just fly those people across. That's Lynn Murray, defensive back. Those outside corners, they just send them across. When they read sweep or maybe any kind of outside play, and what they've been doing is they let them come up and then they'll either option outside of them or turn them up inside. Might look for Warner on a keeper. Good blocking by the fullback Ziegler on two plays.
Gets to the 27-yard line. Syracuse needs about the 22, and that'll make it third and five. 5.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. It is tied at 24.
They haven't run the option in a while, but I'll tell you, they might want to not take anything with drives too deep. They're in range for Gary Anderson for a field goal attempt. It'll be a long one, but I don't think they want to lose too much more, so it'll be interesting to see what they call on third down.
Ball is at the 26, so really there are only 4 yards to go for the first down. This time there's a slot left. Short side, Joe Morris, and Joe will be stopped at the line of scrimmage, and that makes it fourth down, and now the critical call for Coach Dick McPherson. This is where he earns his whole season's pay right here. Gary Anderson coming on the field, and there will be a field goal attempt, or at least they will indicate to the West Virginians that they're going to attempt the field goal. The field goal unit is in.
I think that's exactly what you see. It's a long fourth down. They got about a good 3 yards to go for a first down. Anderson's got a great leg.
This will be 44 yards worth with a slight angle from right to left. The holder, Jeff Fisher. The kicker, Gary Anderson. Kick is up. It is good. It just got there.
I'm not used to seeing Anderson's field goal look short. I've seen him look left and I've seen him look right, but I've never seen him look short. But that was just enough.
A 44-yard field goal, and I tell you, it was 44 yards and 2 inches. Because it just made it over the crossbar. And Syracuse leads 27-24, but there are 4 minutes and 13 seconds left to play. We would like to express our thanks, Dale Dreipulcher and myself, to a lot of people who have contributed to the success of these broadcasts this year, particularly to head coach Dick McPherson and his whole staff. Dick is a genial, friendly, warm, patient guy, and he's had more than enough time for us every time we've needed something. A special thanks to Coach Dick McPherson, all the members of his staff, to Syracuse Director of Athletics, Jake Krauthammel, to Larry Kimball, the sports information director, and his staff, including Michelle Pond, to Tommy Benzel, the manager of the Carrier Dome, Dick Gibney, Associate Director of Athletics, Susan Glassman, Events Manager here at the Carrier Dome, Al Quadrini, the Manager of Maintenance, Linda Myers, the Office Coordinator, Linda Hamilton, Supervisor of Food Service. Our deep and sincere thanks to all of them. Right to the end of the end zone. Takes a lot of people to help provide the success we have had with the broadcast this year. And we are grateful to all the people at the Carrier Dome, Syracuse University Athletic Department, and all the folks, of course, at WCNY-TV, and to all the other public stations across the state who have carried our broadcast and who have been so helpful and cooperative.
Big series now for West Virginia.
Luck to Mullen, hit by Coban and Kilpatrick. 4 minutes remaining.
And he stayed in bounds, and that's going to keep the clock running. Syracuse defense got to watch that big play. Jerry Mullen, that dangerous wide receiver, has shown a real ability to get free down the middle of that zone. But we'll see what happens now. Blaze Winter trying to get everybody excited. Number 98. Like to put some pressure on Oliver Luck, number 12.
Incomplete at the 29-yard line. Right. Rao was the intended receiver. Jet Bay was the guy who was there to deliver the hit.
Good, strong tackle. Made sure the ball stayed. An incompletion.
Luck now unofficially 32 out of 43, 359 yards.
And there's Mike Jetbay, the man who for his play against Pittsburgh was named ECAC Player of the Week. And Syracuse defensive lineman and the team trying to get everybody excited. 3 minutes and 27 seconds away from a possible victory.
Third and six. Luck lets it fly deep downfield. It is broken up. Syracuse had Kilpatrick and Fredrickson, 19 and 22 there. And they were both able to get their hands on the football and bat it away.
Very close to the interception. That ball, when it left Luck in, was underthrown, I can tell. The minute that ball, but then it wasn't going to go up as high as he wanted to. It fluttered. Syracuse had a chance for an interception, but now it's going to be fourth and a long five.
Any chance for a fake punt?
I would say that would be something to watch out for, but...
Sidner, fair catch. Coban makes it at the 34-yard line. They're going to get a penalty on that one. That's all right. 3 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the ball game. Syracuse will have the football.
First, their field position, however.
And it cost them a couple of yards.
Five, I guess, delay of game. It's... Sidner signaled for the fair catch. And then, of course, everybody slows down. And then, of course, number five, Coban caught the ball and started to run with it. So even though there was a fair catch called, the man who caught it hadn't signaled for it. You have to stay right there.
Dead ball foul. They run with the ball. We set the stakes. It'll be first and 15.
All right, five-yard penalty, first and 15.
That's the problem right there. It wasn't the fact that it was 5 yards, but the fact that it's going to be first and 15. If it was 5 yards and first and 10, you'd feel a little bit better. But now Syracuse has got 3:13. They want to run off the clock, and they got to get 15 yards to get a first down.
You know, if this ball game winds up like this too, Dale, the fans aren't going to be able to contain themselves with anticipation and eagerness for next football season. It's going to seem like next September is 100 years away. This has been a great second half of football for a Syracuse University team and a Syracuse University football fans. And they will really anticipate next season with a lot of anxiousness and a lot of enthusiasm. Now this will help recruiting. It'll help sell tickets. It'll help maintain a lot of excitement. And it'll help Coach Vic Person and his family sleep a lot better for the next couple of months.
And I'll tell you what, the people watching this in public broadcasting, it's certainly entertainment from the word go. It's been an exciting football game. 3 minutes, 13 seconds away from a win over a bowl-bound football team. And it's now pressure back on the got nothing. I think it would be advisable for Syracuse to use as much time as possible, because I don't think they're going to be able to get that first down. I don't think they're going to want to throw the ball up. We shall see what's going to happen as the play comes in with Gordon Gronkowski and John Lally checks out.
Joe Morris with 27 unofficially carries, 162 yards.
See, if they can get a first down now, it would be very important. That runs at least another minute and a half off the clock.
To the 37 or 38 yard line. You know, you get caught up in the enthusiasm. You're not supposed to do that, but
I'll tell you what, I got caught up in. I got caught up in the clock was to one when the ball was snapped. They just got that ball up. They almost got called for delay of game. And they're taking all of the 25 seconds. They took 24.5.
Third and seven.
This
2 minutes and 3 seconds. 2 minutes exactly. 8 seconds. Seven on the 25-second clock. Five, four, three. No, he didn't get it. So that stops the clock with 1:47 remaining, and Syracuse will have to give it up.
I thought Warner might run with the ball. Would have kept the clock running. I thought he had a chance to get the first down, but Syracuse again. I hate to keep saying this, but the pressure keeps going back and forth now. Right now, Jay Ross has got the pressure. He's been doing very well today. He needs another one of those 54 yarders.
Let's go, baby, let's go.
And they're using all of this 25 seconds, but they can't take too much more time.
Doesn't matter because the clock's not running.
Right.
Good one, a beauty. At the 14-yard line, Drury. Drury gets it to about the 28. Kaminsky, 37, along with Bingham, Manning, all down to make the tackle. And now West Virginia with a minute and 37 seconds remaining. 3 points behind, 27-24. With 1:32. Second and 10 from the 28-yard line. Zunick and Bellamy check in the defensive secondary. Jet Bay and Siebert come out. Here comes Butsky in, 77.
He'll probably check in for Billy Pendock. Pendock not quite as quick as Butsky.
The referee has Mike back in the first period. He didn't indicate incomplete pass, fumble.
Chris Hand and Mike Charles made a sandwich of Oliver Luck. Watch this. Luck takes a much deeper drop than normal. He's back another 3 yards. There's Hand number 89. Boom! Both sides.
May have been a fumble and recovered by West Virginia, which is why the referee didn't indicate incomplete pass. At any rate, Joe Morris with 27 carries today gives him 261 for the season, and that ties Larry Zonka's 1967 record of 261 carries in a single season. 44 seconds, 43. Luck back to throw, screen pass to Walczak. Walczak hit by Jet Bay. Jet Bay and Siebert. 32 seconds, 31, 30.
And they're going to get a timeout at 30.
West Virginia stops the clock with 30 seconds to go.
You know, I misspoke. I want to give Blaze Winter credit. It was he along with Hand who made that sandwich of Oliver Luck to play before this. Mike Charles was there also, but Blaze Winter has been doing a good job defensively putting a pass rush on. As Chris Hand, a sort of a retreaded tackle turned into a linebacker, has done a good job so far. With 30 seconds left, Syracuse has got to hope that front four can continue to put pressure on Oliver Luck.
We have had a sensational second half of football at the Carrier Dome. At halftime, West Virginia was ahead 17-7. Syracuse now leads 27-24 and is on their way to the fourth win of the season. It doesn't sound like much, four wins out of an 11-game season, but the last two in a row over Boston College and West Virginia is going to give this club a tremendous amount of momentum. I don't know if the momentum can last from now through next September, but it's going to help in a lot of respects. Recruiting, ticket sales, enthusiasm on the campus, and credibility in Coach Dick McPherson and his staff.
I would look for Oliver Luck to hang this one up and hope that he can get an interference penalty.
Intercepted by Romano.
The inbound.
And unless somebody finds a way to stop the clock,
after they set the stakes, that should start up again.
Only 19 seconds to go. Syracuse will get 25 seconds to get the playoff, so they don't even have to snap the ball,
which would be advisable.
Just heard, as a matter of fact, it was 3 years ago yesterday, or tomorrow rather, Dale. Watch the interception.
Overthrown.
That Joe Pisarcik's famous handoff.
That's
3 years
right.
ago tomorrow. I heard somebody talking about that on the radio this morning. 33 out of 47 for Luck, but four interceptions, 369 yards.
Syracuse has to snap the ball in order to get that clock running.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
And they take a delay of game. So West Virginia, who before this was supposed to be headed for the Peach Bowl, but of course nothing official.
Yeah, they're going
to
go anyhow.
Yeah, first down.
Upset the University of West Virginia 27-24 as the Orange registers a 4-6-1 first season for Coach Dick McPherson. Hopefully the beginning of a dynasty for the coach and his staff. He has captured the hearts and imagination of most of the football fans of New York State as Syracuse thinks of itself as really the only college football team in New York State playing a nationwide schedule and carrying the banner of New York State football all across the country. This was a very important win for Syracuse. Not necessarily a significant loss for West Virginia, though this is now five in a row for Syracuse over West Virginia, and the Mountaineers are going to think they're snake bit by Syracuse University. But they will wind up 8-3. They're still going to the Peach Bowl to play the winner of the Florida State game. But I don't think there was any question but what West Virginia came to play this ball game. They outplayed Syracuse in the first half. I think that also was obvious to everybody here, the 30-some-odd thousand fans at the Carrier Dome.
And the fans want Joe to come back out of the dressing room. Joe Morris having...
Well, they're hollering, "We want Joe." Let's see if Joe will come back out of the dressing room. Maybe that they're not aware of it in the locker room, but the fans would like Joe to come out one more time. Unofficially, Joe wound up today with 162 yards, 27 carries, two touchdowns, the other for Dave Warner. Now let's see if he will come back.
You know, he's such a shy kid, it's almost unbelievable, but classic example. I'm a kid who's awed, shucks, but that's the way he is, and I wouldn't be surprised if Joe just stays in the locker room.
Nobody.
everybody's leaving.
The official attendance at a little over 33,000, giving Syracuse 230,000 fans for six home games this year. I see Associate Director of Athletics Dick Gibney down in the dressing room area. He may have gone back in now to see whether Joe will come out one more time. The fans aren't leaving. I don't think they're going to leave. Now the whole team's coming back out. Never mind Joe Morris. They're all coming back out. All the seniors. And Coach McPherson. And Joe Morris. All the seniors. Jetbay, McCullum, Lolly, McAndrews, Zunick, Bethman, Bogosian, Kilpatrick, Bingham. A lot of the Notch seniors out there as well. There's Feldman, number 84.
Here comes Dave Warner.
Sidner is out there. Dave Warner, number 11. Joe Ross, number 16.
Paul Zambuto.
Paul Zambuto, 17. I bet they wish they had four or five more ball games. I'd give anything to start this season all over again.
And there goes Joe Morris. Look, Coach McPherson grabbed him. He doesn't want him to get away. He wants to milk this for all it's worth, and I don't blame him. Joe Morris in Syracuse University got to be excited. They tell him to come over to the home stand.
Joe and the seniors are thanking the for helping him win this ball game, and I think the fan enthusiasm had a lot to do with it. Coach Dick McPherson. Now the rest of the squad comes up. I've never seen this happen before.
What a moment.
And I've been watching Syracuse University football, Dale, for 30 or 35 years. Joe Morris's mother? Could be. That's Joe and his mother.
What a picture! What a man.
Intercollegiate athletics, nothing like that.
No more. One in a million.
Okay, let us express our thanks for a terrific job this whole season to our statistician, Bob Jubinville, our executive producer, Bob Payton, producer, Chuck Dozier III, remote supervisor, Charlie Thomas, our director, Dick Calgiovanni. Again, we would encourage you to write to us if you'd like to see more of this next season. Right to WCNY-TV, Old Liverpool Road, Liverpool, New York, 13088. Thanks to everybody for all their help, their cooperation, their encouragement. Dale, it's been a pleasure working with you. Look forward to doing it again next year. For Dale Dreipolster and myself, Carl Ottenberg from the Carrier Dome, where Syracuse has beaten Peach Bowl-bound West Virginia 27-24.
Major funding for WCNY's production and statewide telecast of Syracuse University football provided by a grant from Carrier Corporation Foundation Incorporated.